I like that Billy's already like trying to just get it over and done with. He's literally like, okay, let's just move on, get it recorded, so like we can just like go on with our lives. Cheers, man. I know we're here for your birthday, but you know, thanks for having us, I guess.
Yeah,
oh, look, Ian's been talking through an intro.
Is it, I need this done before Love Island starts.
I now wanted to run long just to kind of crash that. Anyway, we've recorded already, and as you know, I'm not going to edit that out. So welcome to the SWN Podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. And on this edition, which will be the chaotic edition, is the season 4 finale. It is Billy's Day of Birth Bonanza 2. We've got 8 quiz competitors, we'll call it that. This could go absolutely wrong. I promise there won't be a sing-along at the end, so it'll still be better than the shambles. We'll soon find out. So, joining me on this edition, if you're on the audio stream of it, which, I mean, you can be, but video is probably, video is what you need to be on. I'll introduce all the people in the quiz. We have, up in my top right corner, you heard it right at the start there, it is a guest from episodes 4, 47, and 58. It's Ian Skinner.
So did I, and that's like my
fuck's sake.
He's holding it as well.
Wait, we're allowed to swear?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Usually swear. That's specified for me, nice.
Oh yeah, swearing's fine. It's the last one.
Just stay there. Yeah. Billy's birthday.
I'm going
to
say
to my right, I'm joined by guest from episode 62, the current and forever Laird of the Ring. It is Sean Martin.
It's here. Thank you.
I like the forever part.
Nothing's happening with it. The Velcro doesn't work. It's
that's the issue.
To my bottom right, so to speak, joining me from episodes. Did I write down your episode? From 32 and 156, it is Grant McIvor. Welcome back.
I'll trim my beard. This, that.
Come to me,
that's, that's nasty. I like this, it's all about squares.
Yeah, I'm in the middle. Bunch. It's like the Brady Bunch. Yeah, that's what I was going for. That's what I was hoping for. I thought one of these were going to pull out and it would just look weird otherwise. But thankfully, Destiny.
I never pull out.
Beat me to it, bastard.
What the fuck?
And the poorly phrased below me is Emily Hayden from episode 40.
You may refer to me as Queen's Beach. It's one of the main reasons why I'm here, I'm not going to lie.
I know I sold it to you last year. You were supposed to be on the first one, and then, of course, ICW pulled all my guests last minute. Bastards. But no, I sold it on purely on Queen's Beach alone, and we've got you on now. So to my bottom left, joined me from episode 17 and 50. It's Jason Hyde. Who's actually here this time, because he was supposed to be on the last episode. But...
And do you know what the thing is, right? See how this time, I don't even get to say, oh, anybody died, because somebody did die.
Oh,
I just know the person that stalked me. But I'm here for definite, and hopefully nobody dies within the next kind of...
For definite?
30 and a half. Hey, my guy. Seriously, I'm very traumatised.
Well, let's hope.
Nah, I'm kidding. On.
Let's hope you get an answer right, maybe, and that might cheer you up. To my left, who's dying in the corner, almost going extinct, it is from episode 7, 73, 86, and 164. It's Brodie Adler.
Yes, thank you.
For those that are on the audio stream, she's dressed like a dinosaur, which is. It won't gain any extra points, but I do appreciate the effort.
I'm not just dressed like a dinosaur, Billy. I've got scales. I've got dinosaur jewellery. I've got a backup dinosaur t-shirt just in case I get too warm. I'm drinking, it's dragon soup, but dragons are kind of dinosaurs. I've went through gimmicks for this.
Are you 15?
Huh?
And as you heard of his voice there, from episode 151 to my top left, it's Titanium Tom Atlas. Sorry, Rotom Atlas.
So, speaking of Rotom, right? You know how you don't like him, yeah?
Hate him.
Now,
I hate him.
turned him into Mecha Mummy. Do you like him now?
No.
Not specifically because you've done it, I hate it.
What? You in a barber shop?
Right?
No. Mecha Mummy, no?
No, it's still, too much like Rotom. Boo. And finally, right above me is the man who won Day of Birth Bonanza last year, who's now holding the belt. He's assured me it's been dettled since his Shawn Michaels Playgirl tribute to the,
It's belt. A flora, but it still counts.
Hopefully his rainbow drop. He is competing to retain the belt. He has promised that he will send it. If he does somehow lose the belt, he will send it.
I promise no such thing. Promise no such thing.
You're walking to my end, buddy. You know you are.
It is the Fair City hooligan himself. It's Brent Carter.
Big time Brent is how I'll be referred to from now on.
Why does everyone do this fucking gimmick?
Can I make one request to Brent? See if I win this belt, can you maybe just put it back on with no clothes on to redo it and then send it? Because I'm not really happy that you dettled it.
I don't... Yo, I'm out. Sorry, guys.
It is good seeing everybody.
I mean...
see, here's the thing. The only thing he can make that joke fully work is if he doesn't come back.
Well, we'll see. Once the round actually starts, we'll see if he actually does return.
Oh God, I've just noticed your name, Sean.
That's so good.
Nothing wrong with it.
Right, hold on.
I think I already do.
I think everyone here does attempt, maybe Big Man with the beard there.
Yeah, here's the thing. I'll unfollow you and I'll follow you back just to give you...
Oh, no, I need the ego boost.
Hi, there you go. You're welcome.
Oh, beautiful.
So, while Ian is disappeared, I heard some rumours of something happening in 1999.
Nothing happened in 1999.
Nothing happened. Or 1998.
Allegedly, I was not involved in any events in Chicago or the Chicago surrounding area.
Neil
was
to
do. Did you say allegedly you weren't? Because that kind of means that you're saying that you were.
Ooh. I played the fifth.
Anyway, I fucking hit my microphone here. Right, we're all competing, all eight of you today, not only for Brent Carter's championship belt that he's holding over his head right in front of the camera now, you're also competing for this wonderful trophy that says you're awesome, because the sticker. That's how it came.
I can't explain to you how much I want that. There is nothing I will not do for that. Not only would I die for it, but I actively intend to.
So that's what you're all competing for. This terrible trophy that I will post out to you once the probably by the time this episode will go out, you'll have it. And then you'll be able to put it in a bin or whatever you want to do with it. I'm not going to ask for it back, and it won't be used for the next Day of Birth Bonanza. So it's yours to keep forever, if you wish. We've got 5 rounds of 10 questions. Like I said before we hit record, if we end up doing this for far too long, I will take out a round because, you know, we've all got stuff to do. We're going to enjoy this Day of Birth Bonanza. We're going to celebrate. This is for my last episode, season 4, day before my birthday. Let's just have a fucking wild Wednesday night.
Why did you censor yourself there?
I don't know.
Why did you censor the day before your birthday? This goes out. Like, they don't know when this goes out. That's good. It's the birthday bonanza, not the day before birthday bonanza.
Oh, but it goes out on July 1st. That's the Friday.
Right. Cancel it now. I'll see you the morrow when we're doing it in his actual birthday. We have actual advertising to do this falsehood we're giving everybody. I feel sick. Go anyway, Tay.
Not what we do, man. We can't do this. Not when it's
lads,
not.
It's been nearly 20 minutes. Like,
it's only 20 minutes. We'll get it back.
Right.
Never been to a pub quiz, Skinner? They say half 8. Don't start till fucking 9 o'clock.
He's never been to a pub. Nobody invites him.
Not even wrong.
Do you know, that's a lie because I've been in a pub with him before, so that is a lie.
No, but he's from Edinburgh. They don't have pubs. They have what they call Edinburgh pubs. Edinburgh pub's not a normal pub.
Being in a pub and him sitting drinking elsewhere does not mean you're together, Jason. Just saying.
I feel like I'm a substitute teacher. Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
And that took myself.
Sir, can we have the quiz outside? Can we have the quiz outside, sir?
But actually, if Billy didn't show up within 50 minutes, I'm legally allowed to leave. Yeah.
If the quiz doesn't start in 50 minutes, I'm gone. Bye.
Right, I don't have stuff. So,
we'll 19.
We'll start it now. Well, we're going to do, we've got a poll. The poll out today as recorded. Who's going to win? The results were everyone, well, 31.6% think Brent Carter will retain his Day of Birth Bonanza Championship.
Sensible.
That's just burner accounts.
Quite possibly, because I didn't restrict it to, for voting. Second place was Jason Hyde and Emily Hayden, both with 21.1%.
Why are you voting for me? Why?
Honestly, I wouldn't even argue that for the other side. Like, I should have got her vote staying. None of us have a snowball's chance in hell. I'm too wishy. How am I supposed to win any sort of quiz?
I'll be honest, I think there's maybe like three that are taking this seriously anyway, so it's going to be very interesting.
When I feel like Brent's put in a few votes for himself and then voted for Jason and Emily just to sway it a little bit. To
be
like
fair, I tried to tick every single person except Tom. But it wouldn't let me. I was only allowed to vote for one person.
I mean, nobody likes Tom, to be fair. So.
No, you're not wrong, but you didn't have to say it. What the fuck?
Tom's a little bitch.
Right.
Let's think this is shite. Can we go to question one?
That's what I'm about to do. Don't, like, save your bullying for after the first round. Right, we've got round one, which is called, and I feel like all these are going to fall flat now, because
unless
we get bullied now. The first round is a wrestling round. See, it's a wrestling podcast. It seems like the best way to start. It's called I'm the Quiz and I'm Awesome. That's thank God. I'll take your pity laughs. I'm happy with that.
Uh-huh.
Question one. We're actually starting this. Everyone get your pen and paper ready. Which wrestler won the first Money in the Bank ladder match?
Balls, my pen's not working. It's all right. I'm just going to imprint it on the page.
So we'll ask all the questions and then take the answers.
Well, like fucking carve it into the paper.
Aye, don't test me, right?
that's how we write on rocks. We carve with things before we die.
I don't know about your favorite.
I think you can as a dinosaur.
So that's question one again. Which wrestler won the first Money in the Bank ladder match? All good. Move on.
Yep.
Now question number two. Who was the first King of the Ring winner?
You're asking a question there.
I certainly did.
I don't even know the last King of the Ring winner.
Wade Barrett. Wait, no!
It was
Xavier Woods. Even I know who the last one was, Christ. I know shit about wrestling.
That's question two.
I know it.
Who was the first King of the Ring winner? Okay, all good. Question number three. In which city did Santino Marella make his WWE debut? There's no rhyme or reason for these questions. It's just a random thing of wrestling questions. So there's no pattern at all. So that's question three. In which city did Santino Marella make his WWE debut? All good. Question four. What year did the WWE Network launch in?
Oh, shit.
Where did I live?
No, that's not the question. What year?
Yeah.
I'm aware of what the question is. Thanks. Let's wow.
Heating
up, and it's only four questions in, which is what year did the WWE Network launch in? Question five. What was the name of John Cena's epic rap album released in 2005?
That's a fine figure out a question.
Oh my god, we played it the whole way up to Cave Ness.
Imagine telling folk you've been to Cave Ness.
That's a whole point.
Hiya, I'm Brodie, I get booked.
Unrelatable content, stop.
That was question five. What was the name of John Cena's epic rap album released in 2005?
Have it in that wardrobe somewhere.
You've been in John Cena's wardrobe? Fucking weirdo.
Sorry, you couldn't see me. Smoke in the wardrobe?
told myself I wasn't going to swear. I've effed twice.
That doesn't
you lie to yourself.
I have effed.
I have effed.
Question six. Question six. What country was Cain born in? So that is the man who plays Cain, Glenn Jacobs. What country was he born in?
Shouldn't really talk about him anymore. That's...
Why?
That just sounded it.
Was he born in Cringe County?
he's born a few bridges.
Was cringe. Just that backfired. I'm sorry.
But, yeah. I've been yawning called.
Question six. What country was Cain born in?
It's definitely Bundafshire Bridges, I'll say that.
Question six.
Kind of looks like he could be in Ramstein.
Question seven. Who won the first Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal?
I'm Andre the Giant.
Is it yeah. Andre the Giant?
That's number seven. Who won the first Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal?
Am I the only one having birthday drinks here, by the way? This...
I've got a bit of vodka.
I had a shot of vodka.
Let's just Dr. Pepper because I'm a child.
A shot of vodka? That is boggin.
Sorry, I just
needed something.
Some e-liquid.
I one up you, Skinner. This is better.
Far I don't better. Drink anymore. Like, I've
Someone
stopped drinking.
Someone have an e-liquid?
I'm on my this bad boy.
I don't drink, but I'm
stuck with my diet. I'm ruined. It's what's everybody.
Yeti.
Yeti.
It's the absolute bollocks, Troops, but I'm not sponsored, so they're getting no further advertisement from me.
Not sponsored yet.
Question eight.
Oh, yeah, quiz.
Hard to believe there's a quiz going on. Question eight. Which Superstar's entrance theme includes the lyrics, "They broke the mold when they made me"?
Yep.
That's question eight. Which Superstar's entrance theme includes the lyrics, "They broke the mold when they made me"?
I'm here to fuck your dad. I'm here to fuck your dad.
Right.
Question nine.
No. Oh, never mind. Next question, please.
I don't know why, but I feel like Grant's googling something.
Question nine. What was the name of Michelle McCool's version of the Styles Clash?
Yeah, cool.
I try to remember this one.
Fucking everywhere.
Flippy doobie. That wasn't the answer, no spoilers.
Did Brodie spill her drink?
Here, was that actual question nine? Because if it is, I've got something wrong, because I've put question nine twice.
Yeah, that was question nine.
It comes before nine, by the way, darling.
I'm absolutely dyslexic. This is out of orbit.
Hey,
right, don't do you know what?
Like I don't someone dyslexic. I would dyslexic you more.
Jason, that's dyscalculia, you fucking moron.
Well, I can't spell that.
I don't know if I said question nine twice, I'll do it again. What was the name of Michelle McCool's version of the Styles Clash? And finally, for the end of the first round, what was the name of the 2010 film starring The Big Show?
Aye, sound.
Big Show was in a
movie. Billy, what was that?
That was question 10. What was the name of the 2010 film starring The Big Show?
He's been in a few, so I'm taking a swing at which one could have been that year. But aye, sound.
Fucking ruined my notebook. No.
That's not on fucking me, okay? You can't say I ruined your notebook.
Do you think you should watch
your drink management?
You take it so personally, Christ dinner.
Do you think, Brodie, you're a T-Rex, so you got a big head and small arms.
Anyone
it's
want
little
any
arms
questions?
If you're gonna quote Meet the Robinsons, okay?
Say what any of the questions repeated.
All of them.
Who have I got 11 answers?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Do you know what? I've actually, the only explanation is that I've somehow imagined you saying another question.
Well, we'll find out what that is. So, everyone got answers? How did you feel about that first round? Everyone quite confident?
Horrible.
Smashing.
I feel absolutely soaking, Billy, tell you the truth.
Brodie feels absolutely soaking.
Sensitive subject over here, buddy. I'm covered in dark fruits.
Well, with that. Right, so the answers. Question one, which wrestler won the first Money in the Bank ladder match? Oh, Skitter's put his hand up first.
Egg.
Wow, I wrote Egg.
Correct. Everyone get that?
I just wrote Edge.
Yeah. Did I get bonus points for writing down as well? Or
certainly not.
No. Unfortunately.
Points. I'm sick of that fucking passion.
Was fucking, that was so brown nosy the fucking last time. That, actually.
Yeah, there's no bonus points in this this quiz.
Right, well, it's been nice knowing you, so fuck you, Tom.
Really, because I can't keep track of the bonus points because I couldn't last time.
Do you know what? Just for that, even if I win, I will send you the trophy.
Question two. Who was the first King of the Ring winner?
Ian Skinner.
I don't know. Brett put his hand up.
So I think it was the original Rock, Don Morocco.
Correct.
Smashing.
Who got that?
I was wrong.
I wrote, I'm sorry, I did not get this. Please take this drawing of a cat.
I've just mixed up. See, because Harley Race called himself the king, I've just guessed Harley Race. He just took the gimmick without winning the tournament. What a dastardly man.
So was that, that was just Brent and Grant that got that. Am I right? Yep. Cool. Yeah. Fine. Question three, in which city did Santino Marella make his WWE debut? I think Brodie put their hand up first.
I don't really know anything about wrestling, so I'm just guessing everything. Okay. And I wish I was lying about that. But I said Toronto.
Wrong. Anyone else?
I say Grant. Go with Grant.
All right, Grant.
Given that he was called the Milan Miracle, Milan.
Yep.
It was Milan. Yep.
Yeah.
Right.
Milan a
big one.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Who got that one in?
Yeah.
Brent.
Myself.
Yeah. So everyone but Brodie, Tom, and Sean.
I'm just going to know the fact that Brodie said, how's Milan a city?
I thought Milan was a country.
Jesus me. Hmm. I think we better just leave that line of question at the door right now.
Can someone tell me where it is then?
Italy.
Italy.
Oh shit, that's not.
Wait, hold on a minute. Did you watch Santino Marella all that time and no figure out he was Italian?
He's not Italian.
No. He's supposed to be. Next
year, ironically, he's Canadian.
You're going to try to tell me that Chief Chase Strongbow isn't actually a Native American?
No, he's a Canadian.
Whoever tells you that's a liar and a scum.
Not even a scum bag.
No, just a scum. They don't get the bag. They don't get the 5p government charge.
Question four. What year did the WWE Network launch in? Tom?
2014.
What?
Yep. Yeah, 2014.
Yes.
Yeah. Cool. Was that everyone but Brodie?
I wrote in brackets 999 as well, just saying.
Yeah.
Run that out.
That was too early.
I mean, that's wrong, but fair enough, I'll give it to you. Like,
when do you think it came out, Brodie?
I thought it came out in 2019.
2001.
Oh, no, wait, there was a pandemic.
Specifically.
I thought it's always been it. Nah, I'm joking. I got it right. Don't worry.
So that's 70 you got 2014. Excellent. Question five. What was the name of John Cena's epic rap album released in 2005? Skinner?
Damn by Kendrick Lamar. My time is now.
But not quite.
Wrong.
Well, it's not my time is now.
No.
Is it See Me?
It was You Can't See Me.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Yes. Get in.
See, I was the same. The reason being is that I didn't want to confidently be wrong.
So again, was that everyone except Skinner this time?
Hey. I got it wrong too.
I got it wrong.
Don't just sit there and pretend and make me have to audibly say it, Billy. You know the script, bitch.
Brody.
Certainly as Wednesday.
I mean, I thought I'd invite you back for some redemption since you finished last in the last one, but
it's Jason finished last, technically.
Technically, Jason did finish last, as he didn't turn up.
Actually, I didn't even finish.
Technically, he's still in that first quiz.
Exactly. I've been waiting for yous all this time.
God, it's been Curtis Axel.
Yeah.
The Axeman cometh and whatnot.
Question six. What country was Cain born in? Brent?
I believe that the Cain in Spain falls mainly on the plane.
Correct, Spain.
Jason, you know what's funny? I'm not joking you. That is exactly what I've written down. Like, Jason, literally exactly.
Don't raise your hand ever again. You have fucked up the grid.
It's funny. I'll do it again if you want.
So, how was everyone with that one?
I've done it. Is it
really? That's really... I'm in the middle on my screen. Every time you do that, you fuck off up to the top corner. It moves me. So...
Well, no, he's on over there. It's fine.
Right, everyone got Spain.
No,
yes. Canada.
Right.
Do you even watch wrestling?
I wrote this stuff in nightmares.
So, I think if Andy wrote parts unknown, you deserve a point.
You know what? I did half think about that. That might have been a wee bonus, but I said no bonuses.
No bonus points.
Right.
So, bonus points. Only reason I'm here, bastards.
Right. I'm absolutely fine. So.
Fucking A, Emily.
Brent, Grant, Jason, Ian, you all got that one. Everyone else got it wrong.
Yeah.
Cool. Fine. Seven. Who won the first Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal?
I know this one. Please give me it.
I get it. Yeah.
All right, Brody, go for it.
That's what she
Please
said.
Please tell me. Please tell me it was Cesaro.
It was Cesaro.
Yes!
Yes! I'm so proud of you.
Let's go.
Everyone got Cesaro?
Yep.
Neighbors, I can't do that again. Oh.
And eight.
You think they'll retcon the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal so that he actually slammed Andre the Giant now?
I would say so. Only logical step.
I'm so happy we have Jason back.
My pen works! Yeah.
Yes!
Yay!
Question eight.
Thank you. One scheme, one dream trips.
Which superstar's entrance theme includes the lyrics, "They broke the mold when they made me"? Sean?
This one.
Shrek.
What?
What?
Shrek.
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 Don't, no, oh, okay, no, just no. Don't put your hand up if it's, like, gonna be that, like...
Grant.
No.
Grant's doing it patiently. Hang on, everyone. Grant's put his hand up patiently.
It is Ziggler.
It is Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah. And what are the Shrek. Lyrics to that song?
I am perfection. Perfection.
I mean, Grant is well, bonus I points for singing that.
No bonus points. No bonus points. No
bonus points!
Can I just point out, right, I totally thought it would be Ziggler because he's a big cocky bitch, and I started singing the Miz's music in my head, and I cocky still wrote bitch. Dolph Ziggler.
But they will get Dolph Ziggler. Was that yes. All good? Everyone
yeah,
got
yeah. But
also, I'm sorry for singing his theme.
It's okay. Question nine. What was the name of Michelle McCool's version of the Styles Clash?
Get her.
It was Implant Buster, right?
It was not.
No.
Oh.
Brent?
Faith Breaker.
It was the Faith Breaker.
That's the Implant Buster.
That was awesome.
That was
Kong.
ODB.
Awesome Kong.
Was it?
I've wrote PP Poopoo. Because I had no other alternatives tonight, and I really,
oh,
really
am. I thought the Implant Buster because... The
implant.
Who got that, Brent?
Yeah.
Grant, of course.
Nah, not me.
Faithbreaker one? Yeah, I got
Faithbreaker.
That.
Faithbreaker. Cool. Right, that's fine. As I'm doing the scores.
My nanny, you watch them wrestling. This is... this is not good.
It's fine. You'll get the general knowledge questions.
Were you here last time, Sarah? Do you know me?
Speaking of quizzes, do we get little pieces of cheese when we...
No. Unless you had your own cheese, did you take your own cheese?
I can go get some cheese.
Okay, Master Strachan.
No one has to be the grown up in this situation. It's got to be me, and I don't like it.
I was told there would be punch and pie.
Cheese.
And finally, of the first round, Jesus, what's the name of the 2010 film starring The Big Show? Brent?
Knucklehead.
It was Knucklehead.
Captain Insane.
Oh, that just like the one he's stupid in?
The Big Show movie.
I mean, that's all of them. Alright, so right. You got that then? So, Brent, Tom, yep. Did you get it?
No, I didn't get it.
Alright, okay, Grant, of course. So I think Grant, you've got all them right so far.
I've only got 9.
Oh, fuck. Which one did you get wrong?
I had 9. Faith Crusher instead of Faith Breaker.
Ah, right, okay.
Wait, hold on. I've just
given
you 11 answers. There was definitely 11 questions.
There was not
11.
Hold on.
By process of elimination, what is the question, Jason, that you've got?
Have you fallen through time?
No, it's all right. Never mind.
Right, just double check.
The number 4.
One of them was his name.
Speaking of falling through time, I've got this character where he essentially just quantum leaps into other wrestlers' bodies, but it's still me.
Right. While I'm divvying up the scores, you can correct me if I get this wrong, but while I do that, I've got a question to ask, which was actually requested from the Twitter sphere. Mm-hmm. Would you rather have unlimited bacon but no more games, or games, unlimited games, and no games?
Okay, interesting.
That is interesting, I agree.
Probably
unlimited bacon?
Unlimited bacon, but no video games.
Yeah. I don't like bacon,
unlimited games.
Unlimited video games.
But no games.
I get both.
Funny, but bacon is absolute rank. Like, there's nothing about that. It has no redeeming factors.
It's okay to be wrong.
Is that all right?
I think probably I'd go with games.
Yeah. Unlimited games, but no games.
There's no games.
You can find something else to replace bacon.
No, but how bad would it be if that was just constant, like, unlimited copies of, like, a really shit game?
Right, I think I've got the scores now. You can correct me if I'm wrong, because, you know, that's just professionalism. So in first place, I've got a tie, according to this, with Brent and Grant on 9 points.
No.
No? Right.
No, what? I got 10.
Did you?
That's shut up. No, you didn't.
Legit. Like,
you got Milan. I didn't think you did.
10 out of 10.
Okay, right, okay. Brent, number 1, 10.
Thank you.
Grant, second, 9. And then I've got a 3-way tie for third with Emily, Jason, and Ian on 7.
Yes.
I got 6.
Okay.
I got 7.
6.
Because I got Macho Man for King of the Ring. My time is now for John Cena, Implant Buster, and Captain Insano.
Ah, right, okay, cool. So I appreciate all your honesty, because just give you higher points.
I have no stake in this. I don't want a belt. I've got fucking...
why don't you want this?
I don't want a belt.
Hashtag not sponsored.
Yeah. So we've got Sean and Ian on 6 points then, Tom on 5.
Yes.
And Brodie on 3. So that's the first round.
Every time.
I've still got the support of Duke Cannon either way. I'll be okay.
Second round. It is the 1990s. It is called Edward Quizzerhands. Is the right
name? Okay, I like that one. Okay. That's very good.
I don't know. Some of them are good.
Put me down 0 at this point, Bill.
What?
I was not around.
Right. There's no need to fucking show up.
Congratulations on being young.
Oh, look at me.
I'm little man. I'll be honest, I took a day off the quiz when I wrote Edward Scissorhands.
You're going to squirt a little bit out, you big man, no? You're going to... Titanium, my fucking...
Dick.
I'm wearing 3 pairs of glasses. Literally no one can be smarter than me.
But I got to take my offer.
Question 1. Question of round 2. What opened near Paris in 1994?
What opened?
What opened near Paris in 1994?
Yep.
I will not accept things like some French person's door or anything like that. I have an answer. That's the one you got to get.
You just see Ian Skinner furiously scoring out his answer now.
Question two.
That would be funny.
Question two. What was the name of the first mammal to be successfully cloned?
Sound.
Wait, mammal?
Name of the mammal or the name actual...
First mammal.
What's a mammal?
Nothing. What's a mammal with you?
Shit.
What was the name of the first mammal to be successfully cloned? Question three. What was the name of Ross's pet monkey in Friends?
What's a fucking monkey?
Yo!
What's a mammal?
Oh, it's not Monkey Monday.
A mammal is, well, just for the sake of ease, an animal.
Anything that has a mammal, but genuinely, if it has mammary glands.
Okay, I'm what was happening?
There's a
friend
question
in there. Thank
what was
you.
The name of Ross's pet monkey in Friends?
Yeah, yeah.
Brent's answer is Joey, Chandler, Monica, Phoebe, and Rachel.
Or if it's a boy, Phoebo.
Question four. What game console did Sony release in 1994? I will admit there's far too many 1994 questions in this round.
It's a good year.
Good year.
Can you only remember shit from when you were 3 years old? Yeah.
Four years old.
Oh, were you 90? Oh, you wee old man. That was 91.
I was -2. I was 96.
Question five. The first Harry Potter book was published in 1997. What was it called?
You're just taking the piss now.
That's a point of contention because it's got two different
names. Which one do you want?
I will accept
British
either.
Or American?
I will accept either, but I will judge you if you give me the American one.
Who are these smart arses over here splitting hairs, man? Just tell us what the actual UK one's called, boys. Christ.
That's what we were asking.
You're like Harry Potter. Well done.
Yeah, square gomi at church.
I forgot how you fucking spell it.
I'm not judging your spelling either. Question five, the first Harry Potter book was published in 1987. What was it called?
I was actually listening to that audiobook last night. Weird.
Question six, which book by Irvin Welsh was turned into a hit 1996 film? Which book by Irvin Welsh was turned into a hit 1996 film?
Why are we even asking these questions, man?
Because it's a quiz. Because
Tom's not going to get any of them. Because he's doing, like, a four.
If I know stuff, then it must be too easy. I'm just saying.
See if I get this one, by the way. I'm going to be so happy.
Question seven. If quizzes are quizzical, what are testicles?
Quizzes could quiz, but quiz could quiz. How many quizzes could quiz?
Hey, Grant.
The answer is balls to both seven. Questions.
Hey, right, Grant. What's long and hard and has cum in the middle of it?
Cucumber.
Nah.
Right, we've got to all stop asking questions because Jason will add extras. You'll have 13 by the end of this. We've got question seven. Which UK act won the Eurovision Song Contest in 1997 with the song Love Shine a Light?
Good question.
Thank you.
Speaking of 13 answers, I'll have 13 tapes to send out to people after this quiz.
I'm trying to remember because I had the Now That's What I Call Music that had this fucking song.
Oh.
What's the song called again, Billy?
Love Shine a Light.
Which?
Love Shine a Light.
All right.
Alexa.
Ask me. Come on. Question seven. Which UK act won the Eurovision Song Contest 1997 with the song Love Shine a Light?
Thank you, may I have that?
Question eight. Opal Fruits changed their name to what in 1998?
What are Opal Fruits? Says Sean Martin.
Oh, the Waynes won't know. Up you for being young.
I do. We released them in that packaging.
I'm taking a stab in the dark with this one.
They stopped tasting as good when they changed the name. I don't know how.
The strawberry one stopped being radioactive red. I used to enjoy when they were like that.
Stop giving Tom hints.
So Opal Fruits changed their name to what in 1998? Tom needs all the help he can in this round.
He doesn't just need all the help he can in this round.
He needs all the help he can get.
What about Sean?
I need all the help I can get in general.
Why is Tom getting all the help? No, Sean?
Because he needs it and deserves it.
To be fair, they and something else to make the good a name of a good wrestling move.
What's that?
Yeah, yeah.
Question 9. In which year did the Channel Tunnel open? So it's the 1990s round. You've got at least like
I've got 1 in 10
9 chance. Options. In which year did the Channel Tunnel open?
Well, it was only 5 channels in the 90s. But...
No.
There wasn't, there wasn't channel, 5 up here.
Channel 5 was 2000, wasn't it?
Nah, 98.
No.
And it was the Spice Girls that introduced that.
Speaking of.
Oh, wait. I think question I know 10. The answer to that one.
Question 10. In the UK, Spice Girls dominated the decade, but which of the 5 was the oldest? I will accept their actual name or their Spice name.
Old
the
Spice.
Youngest.
Old Spice.
Yes, money boys.
So the oldest.
Right. Give that man the $10,000.
Who's the oldest member out of them all?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right. Okay.
Which of the 5 was the oldest?
No. Who was the oldest then?
I mean. Yes.
Tom, your white pen looks like you're smoking a massive dub, man. Just saying.
I registered for a powerlifting competition, so I can't anymore. So.
Oh, we get it. You left now.
Yeah, I do.
Just incriminating yourself on a podcast. Smoke weed. All right.
You just admitted a crime, son.
What?
Right, no, guys, we got him.
I will see you in hell.
I'm going that way anyway. It's fine. Don't worry.
The police.
And anyone needing any of the questions reread? Any missed?
Question six.
Which book by Irvin Welsh was turned into a hit 1996 film?
There's a reason I put question mark. Never mind, it's fine.
Number one, could you do that again, just for the year?
What opened near Paris in 1994?
Question 4, part C.
I'll read out anyway. But what game console did Sony release in 1994?
I don't know, but the answer to question 8 is the reason why Cody Rhodes has a kid now.
And you will find out why in a moment. So that's it. Everyone got answers? Everyone good?
Yeah.
Cool. Right, we're getting through this now. We've got this. Question 1. What opened near Paris in 1994?
I don't know, but Kanye West and Jay-Z were there.
No, a few years later.
Not yet.
Right, Brent.
Disneyland Paris?
Correct. I would have accepted Euro Disney as well.
Yes.
I wrote Disneyland, comma, bitch.
That's, what is it?
No, that was Emily's answer.
Emily's answer was Disneyland, comma, bitch.
I've got respect for the gimmick.
Thank you. That's it, Brodie.
Right, so who got that? Everyone got that?
Yep.
No.
No Sean, no Tom. Brodie, you get it?
I got one!
Yes!
Here, what's the problem with Mickey Mouse's airplane?
Oh, I don't know.
Disneyland.
Also
laughed. Oh, fucking hell.
Right, question what's 2. The language, Tom?
What was the name of the first mammal to be successfully cloned? Emily.
Dolly the sheep.
It was Dolly. Dolly the sheep. So everyone good?
No.
No. Yeah.
No.
I'm not good, but I'm past the point where we're supposed to be. So yes.
Right. So that was just Sean, Tom, and Ian that got that.
Hey!
I got that.
I got it.
Didn't get it. No.
I got it.
It all shout once. Come on, right? Okay. So Brent was a no.
I got it.
You got it, right. Sean, do you get it?
No.
Okay. Just pushing it. Grant, you get it?
Yep.
Cool. Emily?
Yep.
Yeah, you did because you gave me the answer.
Yep.
Brodie?
Yeah, bitch.
And you didn't know what a mammal was. Tom, that was a no.
No.
Jason?
Yes.
The shade of it all.
Ian?
I wrote Avril Lavigne.
Right. So,
the reason I know that is because I've actually got a terrifying phobia of sheep.
It does
sound like a joke. Genuine shoot, I do.
You ever been face to face with a sheep?
Aye, that's how I got my phobia. I accidentally nearly killed one and then it tried to kill me back.
This is getting a bit too dodgy and sketchy for me. I'm going to bow out this conversation.
What would win in a fight? The two of them or a cow?
Oh, here we go.
Question three. Question three. What was the name of Ross's pet monkey and friends?
Marcel.
Marcel. Marcel. Yeah. Yep.
I cannot believe I got the friends
thing
question.
Grado says.
It's Marcel.
But that was everyone, was it? Everyone got
yeah.
that?
Yeah. No, I wrote in capital letters, friends is overrated.
RNG as fuck, bro.
I mean,
look at me, I'm Tom, I feel lifting now. Friends is overrated.
Well, my name is Tom, friends is overrated.
Is this episode going to be like...
He's just saying that because he doesn't have any.
That's a fucking edgelord.
This episode's going to be
Brent,
Tom Atlas gets bullied slash
like
quiz.
That, what the fuck?
Right, what game console did Sony release in 1994?
Piss Brody. On me.
Is it the PS1?
I'll accept it. It was just PlayStation.
Oh my fucking god, Tom.
Almost bought one last week.
Alright, was that everyone? Everyone got PlayStation?
No, I heard the wrong fucking thing and I wrote the wrong thing. God damn it.
Okay, how could you hear the wrong thing?
Fuck no. Fuck no.
What
Skinner,
did you write?
Knows.
He's clearly not been working out his ear muscles, has he?
Here's the thing. You said you were working at not seeing you.
No.
So
Tom, what did you write, though?
I wrote Sega Saturn because I thought I heard Sega.
Right.
I thought I heard Sega because I'm a dumbass.
If somebody said Sega, they would say it properly. That's not how you pronounce Sega. It's pronounced Sega.
What's Tom getting done? He's getting torn to pieces, man.
I know,
he lives in Bridgend.
It's bad days when I'm being the merciful one.
He just pronounced Sega. That's what he done wrong.
It's Leviosa.
Speaking of, next question. The first Harry Potter book was published in 1997. What was it called?
There's two, but I've got both.
I'll go, Jason.
What was the first one, Jason?
I've wrote both, but I've wrote Philosopher's slash Sorcerer's Stone.
Both of them are technically right, but Philosopher's Stone is what I prefer.
Mm-hmm. I've got a point in this round. Holy shit.
Everyone got that?
Yep.
Yes. I fear what Ian's written down. Did you actually write Philosopher's Stone, though?
No.
No.
I did, and then I scribbled it out. Because,
You scribbled it out and then put what?
What did you write?
Oh.
What?
I'm just here having a good time, guys,
Hey, the fact that you're still here after walking out in the first minute is commendable.
Well, I need to atone for my sins.
Which book by Irvin Welsh was turned into a hit 1996 film? Brody.
Trainspotting.
Fucking hell, I got that one.
Correct. Trainspotting. Everyone? Everyone but Tom.
No.
That can just be the tagline for this episode. Everyone but Tom.
Okay. Who else but Tom? I feel so bad for Tom. Hopefully he's going to rally back and get the next 30 questions right.
I'm that kid.
He does something live on air that surprises everyone.
Let that one breathe.
I just missed something there entirely. I don't want to know what it was.
Which UK act won the Eurovision Song Contest 1997 with the song Love Shine a Light? Brent.
Katrina and the Waves.
Katrina the Waves.
Fucking yes. I didn't get that one.
I wrote Not Cannibal Corpse, that's for sure.
I wrote The Beautiful Corn.
Can I get a point since that's technically
correct? Of course. I mean, so Katrina the Waves.
Beautiful.
Okay, I'll just, right.
I wrote If It's No ABBA, I don't care.
ABBA aren't from the UK.
Are you sure it wasn't
the UK? I wrote If It's No ABBA, I don't care. Don't fucking question me.
Right, so from my understanding then, it was Brent and Grant that got that, nobody else?
No.
Excellent. Fine. Get better with the scoring. By round five, I'll actually be able to do it.
Grant, if you want to put the cap on, it's the other side.
I'll put the cap on.
Hang on. Did I say there?
Question eight. Opal Fruits changed their name to what in 1998? Jason.
Starburst.
Starburst.
Well, that was amazing, Jason. Yeah.
I know that sounded exactly the same way.
That wasn't me. That was Brodie. You prick.
You fucking sound the same.
Right, who got that one then?
Yeah.
Me.
John, Brent.
I did.
Jason, Grant, everyone. Did right. you? Tom, did you get it?
Are you fuck sake?
Oh, Tom, you little loser. I'm
what
just
did you
saying
put for
it, Ian? Right.
Don't say that to Tom, he might get.
Get what?
If you want it.
He'll get you cancelled.
Right.
Go for it, I dare you, try. I'm right. spotless, mate.
Fucking do it. Just put us out of misery. Cancel us.
Hold on. I'm just gonna.
Please. Let me get a console job.
Ian, what did you put? Did you put Opal Fruits?
Put Starburst.
Oh, Starburst. Oh, yeah, that's the correct answer. Yeah. Good. That's fine. in which year did the Channel Tunnel open? Brent?
1994?
Correct. 1994.
Bastards.
Right. Oh, yo, hold up, okay. I put Channel 4, can I?
No.
Billy's being strict this year, it's great.
Because we knew it was the 1990s, and 4 is in the answer, and it is the Channel Tunnel.
Skinner, just...
Still no. All right.
Skinner,
who got that? Raise your hands. Brent, Emily, you did not get it. Jason, okay. Fine, you'll just have to correct me with my scoring again, but I think I'm getting it right this time. Last one. In the UK, the Spice Girls dominated the decade, but which of the five was the oldest? Emily?
Was it Baby?
It was not.
Brent? Her name was Baby. Baby
Ginger.
It was Ginger.
Ah. Yes! Hold on, I'm fucked up. Is Ginger Jerry Halliwell?
It yes. is, yes.
Fucking got it.
What a guess. Oh, holy
right,
shit.
LB.
Right,
ooh,
who
bastard.
Who got Jerry?
Baby.
You get it, Sean?
Who guessed that Baby yeah. was the eldest?
Me?
Consider your position on this. Her name is Baby.
That's a baby face, shut up.
You
leave me a baby button on.
I'm sorry.
Right, so from my calculations, it was Brent, Tom, and Jason that got that. Anyone else? No, we're all good. Excellent. Right, so talk amongst yourselves while I get the scores wrong.
So I think, because I'm not a big fan of bacon myself, I like video games. So I think, like, if I was to, like, have the bacon unlimited without the games.
Mm.
Yeah.
But the thing with unlimited bacon, if you have so much bacon, you're going to get sick of it.
Yeah,
and unlimited games.
That sounds like something a man...
He's realizing he's literally have unlimited bacon. There is no limit to the amount of bacon you can have.
Exactly.
Well,
that's the dichotomy, really.
Unlimited games.
How much do you like? Yeah, you get unlimited games.
Yeah, but no games.
Yeah,
but you're
no
not
games.
Stuck to like one singular game. You can choose a shit ton. Whereas,
Tom, I don't think you're taking games.
Unlimited games, but no games.
If
it's specifically video games, I'll take that anyways. But imagine it's like you can just play hopscotch whenever you want and shit.
Ellie, what have you done, man?
But it's no games.
Right. Nothing's unlimited. Right. You only have so many games in the world. You only have so many piggies. What if you were to kill all the pigs and eat all the bacon and then there's no pigs to make
but
more
no,
pigs?
No, because you get unlimited bacon. But no video games.
It's not unlimited if you eat all the bacon and kill all the pigs.
But you have unlimited.
And there's no more pigs.
It never ends. Un means no.
Right, we can park that for a moment. Right, the scores. So again, correct me if I'm wrong. But for that round, I've got Brent with 10.
Yeah.
In second place, I've got Jason with 9.
Yep.
In third, I've got Grant and Emily with 8.
Yes.
Brodie with 7.
Not last.
I've got Sean and Ian with 5.
I don't think Brodie was last.
Wait. No, I got 3.
3? Right, what did you get wrong?
Wait, 4. Marcel, PS1. Starburst and Channel 4.
Oh, right. Okay. So 3. No.
Chancer.
Am I really chancing if I if I say it?
Yes. Yeah.
There we go. Right. Yeah. So, after two rounds, we've got Brent in first place with 20 points, full marks so far.
You will take this title from my cold, dead hands.
We've got thanks.
Grant with 17.
Google title on it.
Jason with 16. Emily with 16. Sean with 11. Brodie with 10.
Not last.
Ian with 9. And Tom with 7.
Fuck.
Round 3.
Watch your profanity.
Round 3 is Benny's Quizmatic Universe.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck.
No.
Oh,
I'm out.
I'm out.
I'm out.
No,
no,
no.
Wait,
this man is a torturous human being.
Before we go into it, fuck you, Benny. Fuck you very much.
Aye.
Oh, Benny.
These are glasses. Horrible. Did he do the one where he translated the film titles? Because those ones are mean.
No, no, he did not. But they're all really shit questions, I'll be perfectly honest with you. I didn't know the answer to this.
I could honestly come up with a film quiz right now off the top of my fucking head.
Question one.
Really ask,
but, question number one, what was the name of the man in that film with the fella?
Oh, I know.
Oh, Hingway?
How have you got access to my
question? Aye, fucking... Jason's got it. Jason's got it. Bye, Jason.
The bold himself.
Right.
Jason's got it. Point man.
To which film? Hang on, there's my right. Which film does the following quote belong? Thank God I die a true American.
Say
the quote again.
That's which film McDonald's does the following quote belong? Thank God I die a true American.
Fogging film, anyway.
Pure guesswork for myself this time.
That's been my entire fucking play so far. So,
some name from American film.
Wait, take a stab at
that one. I was skeptical, but okay.
In which film would you find the characters T-Bird, Tintin, and Top Dollar?
Ah!
Oh, yes!
Can you repeat that, please, Billy?
Question two. In which film would you find the characters T-Bird, Tintin, and Top Dollar?
Fuck.
Top Dollar's a cool name.
He's a shit wrestler, though. None of them are cool names.
Is it Bluntman and Chronic?
Question three. I think you're all going to get this one, I would hope. In The Waterboy, what is the name of Bobby Boucher's favourite wrestler, played by Paul White?
Fuck you, Paul Billy. Lee. I hope you die in your sleep.
Oh. Thanks, Billy.
Twirls like that in a world where you can be everyone, be kind, and he's like, die in your sleep, Billy, please cancel Ian Skinner at once as a matter of urgency.
That was In The Waterboy. What is the name of Bobby Boucher's favourite wrestler, played by Paul White? Question four. In the 2011 film Warrior, which wrestler plays the Russian fighter Koba?
Are you sure these are films?
Yes.
I've seen that one. To be fair, that one I think
it's been ages since I've watched it.
That's a good film. That.
That's question four. In the 2011 film Warrior, which wrestler plays the Russian fighter Koba?
The ending of that film is very weird.
Yeah. To be fair, the Kevin Smith parody of that is actually half decent for a happy Madison kind of film.
What is it?
Is it Here Comes the Boom?
Kevin James.
Yeah. I was going to say, not Kevin Smith. Yeah. I got very confused.
Kevin Smith.
Well, Kevin Smith is Blackman and Chronic.
That's
another reference. We're past Warrior. That reference. Keep up with the references.
Question five. In 1954, Barry Nelson became the first actor to portray which character?
Barry Nelson?
Yeah.
Barry Nelson. In 1954, Barry, B with a B. Okay. B for Billy.
Okay.
That was my shoot job coming through there. Fucking
shameless.
That's where I used to live down the street for a boy called Barry Nelson. They used to throw cabbages at Wayne's when they played Chappies, though.
He's in the jail now.
No,
I'm
sure he did actually.
died in the jail now.
died in the jail for cabbages.
Question six. In which year was No Holds Barred released?
I definitely wasn't 2020.
I need to remember SummerSlam.
That's an entire guess, but fuck it.
Question six. So which year was No Holds Barred released?
Ooh. Ooh, yeah.
Billy, I'd like to lodge a complaint about this entire round, please.
You can lodge it directly to Benny.
Is it... Billy, what was that question again?
In which year was No Holds Barred released?
Alexa.
I'm trying to think.
What year was No Holds Barred released?
I literally done that 10 minutes ago, Grant. Get your own partner.
Grant,
I can't hear it. I've got my headphones on.
Grant, little question. Stan Hansen is in No Holds Barred, but Jean LaBelle is in Kickboxer, right?
I know for a fact that's wrong.
I know Jean LaBelle's at least met Steven Seagal.
No, Jean LaBelle is in Roadhouse.
Is that what it is?
Roadhouse.
Yeah, him and Terry Funk are both in that.
Randy the Ram Robinson's final
Steven
match.
Seagal, shit himself.
Yes.
Hi. That was actually worth you interrupting me there. That's fine. I was okay with that. Randy the Ram Robinson's final match in The Wrestler takes part in which promotion?
Shout out!
All Elite.
Shout out to Run the Truth Killings and Cesaro.
Nick
the Butcher. Needs to be the next thing made on Twitter right now.
I want the Wrestler too, where he just gets that All Elite graphic.
So that's question seven. Randy the Ram Robinson's final match in The Wrestler takes part in which promotion?
What a shite finish, by the way. Double axe handle off the top.
It's not a good...
Ram Jam.
It was a killer finish.
Psychology, son. Google it. I know nothing about psychology. I don't know why I said that.
Right, this one's... this is probably the worst question in the lot. There are only two characters in film history to have been played by two actors who both won Academy Awards for the role. Name them both.
What the ever-living fuck is this question?
I'm not having fun.
Question eight. There are only two characters in film history to have been played by two actors who both won Academy Awards for the role. Name them both.
Fuck them both is my answer.
See this question? Can I just clarify? Yeah. Is this a point for both of them or a point for each one you get?
I will give you a point for each of them.
Can you ask the question again, but maybe slower?
I'll do my best. Question eight. There are only two characters in film history to have been played by two actors who both won Academy Awards for the role. Name them both.
Is that technically the same character played by two?
Yes.
Wait. So there are two characters.
So two characters, they've been played by two actors who both won Academy Awards for that role.
Wait a minute, so there's...
So two actors played the same character and both got awards, yeah?
It's a four... Maybe it's a four actors? Yeah.
There's four actors, but I'm only looking for the characters.
So you're wanting the name of the two different actors?
I want the name of the two characters.
Got it.
Yeah. So two actors played the same character and they both won Academy Awards for that role. And the characters.
One possible, I don't know.
Honestly, again, the ones I've wrote are just fucked up.
I think I've got you now, Billy.
Genuine guesses.
If you get any of them, I said, lodge all your complaints to Benny. But I've got a medal as well. I will send you a medal if you get them both.
Fuck you, Benny.
Fuck you, Benny.
I'll send it in the chat and
we
can all send it at the exact same time. I think I've got it, so I'm happy with it.
Question nine. In Disney's Robin Hood, what kind of animal is the Sheriff of Nottingham?
Sheriff?
I remember. Oh, the Sheriff. Oh.
I've not seen that.
That's question nine. In Disney's Robin Hood, what kind of animal is the Sheriff of Nottingham?
And finally,
question 10. Which member of Evolution was last to make their feature film debut?
Got this in the bag. I've at least got one right.
Actually, hold on. Yeah.
Wait.
I think that's right.
Fuck's Evolution.
What?
What?
Did we all hear the same thing?
Right? You really shouldn't have said that out loud.
Oh no, that was an inside voice.
I know the pat is lying right now. What's question nine?
Question nine is, in Disney's Robin Hood, what kind of animal is the Sheriff of Nottingham?
Fuck.
What's question two again?
Question two, in which film would you find the characters T-Bird, Tintin, and Top Dollar?
What was question five, bud?
Question five, in 1954, Barry Nelson became the first actor to portray which character?
Oh, I wasn't alive, so, yeah.
Well, none of us were, to be fair.
We also take that into consideration, neither was Benny.
Right.
Fuck you, Benny.
We're all ready to get the answers on. Two rounds left after this. We've got this. Question one. To which film does the following quote belong? Thank God I die a true American. Emily?
I think it's Gangs of New York.
It is Gangs of New York.
Oh, fuck! Last night.
Cool, right. Everyone get that?
I got it.
No. Yeah. Buddy Tom as a no.
Of course not.
Yeah. Fine. Question two. In which film would you find the characters T-Bird, Tintin, and Top Dollar? Ian?
The Crow, starring Brandon Lee.
It is The Crow.
Stan Lee's son.
See, I was going to either watch that or The Craft last night, and I watched The Craft.
That's a good movie as well, to be fair.
I wrote Cars 4, even Cars there.
No, well, who got that?
There is a scene with a car. Mm-hmm.
Fire it up.
Right, Sean, did you get that? Yeah. Excellent. And Grant, you didn't.
I did not.
Emily, did you get it?
Yes.
Did you give me the answer? Fuck, I've done that twice now. Right, okay. Question three. In The Waterboy, what is the name of Bobby Boucher's favourite wrestler played by Paul White?
Bigfoot Bannington.
We'll go to Ian.
Captain Insano shows no mercy. Yeah.
Captain Insano. Cool. Is that everyone?
Yeah.
Not for Tom. Brodie, do you get it?
I really need to start watching some stuff on TV, man.
You need to take in more pop culture.
So I think it's not The Big Show, no?
It's Captain Insano, though, was the answer we were looking for.
Shows no mercy, in case you don't hear.
Question four. In the 2011 film Warrior, which wrestler plays the Russian fighter Koba? Brent?
Kurt Angle.
It's Kurt Angle.
It's 2011, it's Kurt Angle.
Cool.
I thought for writing Big Show because I'm really, really bad at this.
No bonus points. We've established this.
Of no course. Petty points, Isla.
Petty point? Question mark.
Right, who got that one?
That Kurt Angle Grant. One? I got that too.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. In 1954, Barry Nelson became the first actor to portray which character? Ian?
Jim Bond.
Correct. James Bond.
Yes.
Okay, so that was Brent. Sean, was that? You get that? No. Okay. Grant, aye. Emily, aye.
No.
Brodie? No. Tom?
I love how you've got to the point where you're barely even asking me. Of course I'm not fucking got it.
Jason. Oh, don't get fucking bitter at this stage.
He was so confident.
I know. Okay. I came into this like, yes, I'm gonna win this, and
Jason, did you get it?
I did.
You did. Excellent.
I don't even like James Bond.
In which year was No Holds Barred released, Brent?
I'm thinking because of the SummerSlam. 1989.
Correct. Cool. So that's Brent. Emily,
yep.
Grant, you got it. Cool. Jason, you get it?
Yep.
Cool. Fine. And everyone else? Ian, did you get it? Did. Fine.
I must have been thinking of something else. 2004 is a little bit too far off.
Nah.
A little bit.
I thought you were going to say 2001 and I'd be like, well, you're close.
Well, Randy the Ron Robinson's final match in The Wrestler takes place in which promotion? Ian?
Well, I'll put it to Jason because he had his hand up first.
All right, sorry, Jason.
Oh, Ring of Honor.
It was Ring of Honor, correct.
Mother.
You didn't actually write All Elite, did you?
Of course I didn't. I'm not that stupid. I'm just a
little... You've proved otherwise to me.
Mate, shout out to that match with Necro Butcher, though.
Yeah.
Is it anybody else at the stage where they can't watch past that button now?
Well, no, I just don't watch that film anymore because I get too sad.
Yeah.
Also, the saddest part of that film is when he calls his daughter on the payphone because it's got two eventualities. Either he's too poor that he doesn't own a phone. Secondly, he doesn't want her to know he is calling her, so she picks up.
Jesus Christ, can I be a man? Just watch it.
Emily, did you get that one?
No.
No? Okay, cool. Right.
Actually, I think that's sexist of you to say be a man. Right, I think you should.
Yeah.
Don't be a bully, be a star.
That's toxic masculinity there.
I don't care.
Question 8. I'm just going to power through. I'm just going to let you bully each other and I'll just power through the questions. There are only two characters in film history to have been played by two actors who both won Academy Awards for the role. Name them both. Ian.
Dave Schultz and John DuPont.
Incorrect. Grant.
Vito Corleone.
Yes.
For De Niro and Brando, and then Joker with Legend Phoenix.
Yeah, that's it. Two points.
Nice. Yeah. Oh my god! I can't believe I got that.
I will.
I wrote The Godfather.
Did get both of those?
I got Godfather as well, but I didn't get Joker.
I got both.
Right. Okay.
One point.
Actually, see, just to be completely honest with you, here it says Joker plus, and then Hitler scribbled out for The Godfather.
Right. Okay, I'm going to have to go through you one at a time just so I know who's got what. So, Ian, what did you get? You got both?
No.
Oh, yeah, you gave me the wrong one. See, I'm really good at paying attention to this. Jason, what did you get? You got?
I got both of them, but I wrote Godfather and not Vito specifically. Does that still count?
I'll accept it.
Nice.
Tom, what did you get? You got one?
I wrote fuck them both because no clue.
Okay, fine. That's a good point. Brodie?
I got Joker. I got one.
Yeah. Emily?
I got Vito.
Vito. Grant, both. You could give them both. Sean?
Both.
Both. And Brent, both.
Both.
Tom?
Well, I did promise to send a medal to you, but I've only got one, so, you know.
Tom, take a hint from the Joker. Get in the fridge.
Get in the fridge.
Get fridge.
Question 9. Well, Tom's there.
Oh,
in Disney's Robin Hood, what kind of animal is the Sheriff of Nottingham?
Was he a lion?
He was not.
That was a king. That was King George.
Was it Emily? It was a wolf.
A wolf? Yes.
Oh, I can't think of
it. Really wrote wolf.
A wolf.
It's like a big, fat, grey wolf.
The lone
I've wrote hound, but what I've done is I've mixed
up Baron Corbin.
Robin Hood with the fox and the hound.
Oh my god.
I saw one. Animals is animals in that, do you know what I mean?
Right, okay. Just going to double check again. Brent, you got that?
Yeah.
Sean?
No. Oh,
okay. Grant, you did, didn't you?
Yep.
Cool. Emily, you got it. Brodie? No. Okay. Tom, you did, because I saw you celebrate. Jason was a no, because he's a pound. And Ian? Take it as a no, or you're injured. Okay, right. Last one. Which member of Evolution was the last to make their feature film debut? Jason.
It was Ric Flair and Magic Mike.
It was Ric Flair and Magic Mike.
Yes!
That is the strangest cameo in any movie.
Was Ric Flair not in No Holds Barred? No. No, not No Holds Barred. What's it called? David Arquette.
One Night in China?
Oh, Ready to Rumble. No, he wasn't in Ready to Rumble. No, he had been in TV stuff, like he had been in Baywatch, but Magic Mike was his first movie. I don't know why I fucking know this stuff.
Can I ask a question on that? Like, see, Ready to Rumble, what year did that come out?
2000.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what I was trying to answer earlier. And, the question.
So, right, so Ian, you got that, you didn't get that one. Emily, you get it?
No, I didn't get that one.
Cool. Sean?
Yep.
You did. Excellent. All right, okay, so again...
are you going to ask me?
Did you get it?
Of course I fucking didn't. But it's not the point. You should still ask me just in case.
No!
I did.
No!
Right, you go
just
back
like
to the,
Tom,
the bacon
we
chat.
Assume you didn't get it.
Nobody asked you, Skinner.
Shut up, Tom.
Yeah, fuck off, Tom.
Sake, Tom.
Get in the fridge.
I'm going to give Tom bonus points right at the end.
No bonus points!
Bonus points! No bonus points!
That's like that woman that's in the class that tells everybody not to bring pomegranates into her class. Have you seen that?
No, what the fuck?
What the pomegranates?
No wire hangers!
Thank you!
It says no bonus points on here. Oh, they've got this all wrong. It should say no bonus points.
Bonus points.
So unlimited games, yeah. But no games.
No games.
Games, yeah.
Unlimited.
Yeah, games was a given.
And no games. Games.
Unlimited games.
Unlimited games.
But no games.
But no games.
Or
no
games. There's unlimited bacon.
Bacon. But
no video games.
I think you need to see Anderson's other question, Skinner.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, it's not as interesting. So if you were drunk, do you think you could beat Anderson Silva in a fight?
Who?
Fuck off, Brody. Get in the fridge with me.
No.
Can I just ask what the specification is of like if I was drunk? Because I don't think I could beat him sober.
Oh, yeah.
No, but if you were
obviously, no one could beat Anderson Silva when they're sober. But if you were drunk.
Is he also drunk?
Is it?
No.
No, wait, he's sober.
No.
Is it, could I beat him if I was drunk or if I am drunk, do I think I would beat him?
What, both?
All right.
No, 2 minutes. No, Tom's like, is the fight taking place on 420 by any chance?
No, but Brent, remember, you're drunk.
I'm drunk.
Yeah. So do you think you could be him if you were drunk?
Right.
Well, it depends on if I had unlimited bacon.
But no games.
But no games.
Okay. Right.
And zero bitches.
We'll come back to that at the end of round four. Right. So my totals I've got here. Are Brent with 11 points for that round, Grant with 10
because it was two points for
two points for the question eight. Got Grant with 10.
I've got 8.
Wait, what?
1, 2, 3, 4.
I've just got you got the crow wrong.
8, yeah. No, I got the first one wrong and the James Bond question wrong.
Okay.
Honest quizzer here. There's no pride in cheating. Well, this is a wrestling match.
Oh, there's always pride in
that. So I've got Jason with 9.
Pure Hunters are pride. I've got 9.
9. Excellent. Got Emily pride, and Ian and Sean with 7.
Yes.
One sec. Yes.
I've got 6.
You got 6.
Wait, no. I got 9 because I got the Joker and Don Corleone.
Skinner, are you eating Cocoa Pops?
Are they dry as well? Because I didn't see you put milk in them. I've been watching you periodically.
And we've got Brodie and Tom with 1 point.
Hey!
So that leaves the score so far. In first place, with 31 points, is
that's
Carter.
Number one.
Second, I've got Grant and Jason with 25.
That's number one.
Emily with 23.
Yay!
That's not number one.
Sean with 17.
Far from it.
That's Wanger num.
Let's rotate the board.
Cody with 11 and Tom with 8.
Right, that's all well and good, but let's circle back here. Are you eating them without any milk, Skinner?
Question one.
He's done.
Go get Weetabix. Just eat those
dry. Can I ask a question?
No.
No, that's Billy's job.
He just said,
that's Billy's job.
You had a question?
Anyway, see, for those that are drinking copious amounts of cider.
No bonus point.
Did he ask for a bonus
point?
Wait,
do you need a toilet break?
You should have put a catheter in. You should have put a catheter in. You knew this was happening.
You're a man.
I don't need a piss break because I am the piss break.
I've got my catheter in as well, Brody. Like, did you not get the memo?
I'm just brought a ball.
Thanks to Brent for being the only cunt that laughed at that.
You should,
I laughed.
Violating myself for the sake of a shitting podcast. Are you kidding me? I dressed myself up as a dinosaur and put scales on my face. Is that not enough?
Still doing
nobody
shit.
Nobody asked you to do that.
2 hours later.
Right. Generally, is it like, show of hands, who needs a piss? We'll take a piss break if we need to.
I'm grabbing a cup of tea, fuck this.
Oh my god, you're so...
That would not piss!
So hard!
No,
piss! If ever these days in a piss break, I'm
unless you grab a cup of piss!
I'm going for a piss, then making a cup of tea.
You know what, I'm just going to go for one.
Right, okay, right, really we'll come back in a couple of minutes, we'll go for a piss.
Okay.
We've got two rounds left, and then we can all forget this ever happened.
I'll just wait here then, shall I?
Yes.
Right, I'll hold the fort.
Depends, I mean, if you say stuff, interesting stuff, I just won't cut it out.
Cool. I'll stay, I'll rally. I've got some poems.
A few moments later.
But yeah, I'm going to go for a piss, so you could...
Right,
yeah.
I've got a question.
Red's in charge.
That's cool.
So, walking away, how do you make the perfect cup of tea?
I don't care, Tom.
Piss. And you get my notes app up, I'll read some poems that I've wrote.
Oh, yo, do you want to hear some, like, stand-up bits that I've got?
Yes, always.
Audible. I thought that's just when you took edibles and imagined what the book was like.
I think my sister's back from her dancing show, so that was a really strange piss experience for me, just walking out of my room, she's just standing at my door looking at me, I'm like, oh god.
Just so you know, Billy isn't cutting this out, so just, like...
Where's my sewing kit? This tin is full of
biscuits.
Don't
care. Oh, sorry. He's not cutting this out.
Sorry, Ian, where's your sewing kit?
It's my phone, yeah.
I don't know, my tin is full of biscuits.
Is it full of biscuits? That's...
What tin is it? Latin is like the VHS/DVD of languages. Nobody uses it anymore, and if you read anything in Latin, it's definitely a curse.
Ian, my next question is, what's your thoughts on the Union Claw horse case?
Boy,
Billy, that's my question. Yeah, what do you think about the Union Claw horse
case
scandal?
Yeah, what do you think of that?
I have no fucking clue what you're on about.
Do you have any close relations to
Mr. Hands?
Sorry.
What, Mr. Hans?
The guy who got fucked to death by a horse.
Whoa!
We don't talk about Mr. Hans.
I went to school with the guy who went on a register because he whacked the horse in a field naked.
Right, I have a riddle. I have a riddle that I invented, so it's shit, but I want to see if any of you can get it. Right? A duck, an owl, a hen, and a seagull are all placed inside a large enclosure. Hidden somewhere inside the enclosure is an arrangement of various vegetables. The enclosure is also filled with trees, bushes, tall grass, quicksand, different species of plants, small bodies of water, and an assortment of other obstacles and distractions scattered throughout. The birds are each placed in a different corner of the enclosure at the same time. Which one of the birds will find the vegetables first?
Paul Burchell.
I have a question.
Yes.
So towards the end, you started saying the birds were put in each corner.
Yeah.
I'm assuming that you didn't say squirrel at any point.
No, no. So there's a duck, an owl, a hen, and a seagull. Oh. They're in this enclosure with lots of different, like, fucking shit and distractions. And there is an arrangement of various vegetables hidden in the enclosure somewhere. Which one out of those four, a duck, an owl, a hen, or a seagull, which one of them will find the vegetables first?
Owl!
It's like La. You are El Rata Alada. Come on, what are you showing me here?
See, I never said I'd give bonus points, but we'll take points away.
I'm gonna lose. Tom's here. I'm not gonna be in last place no matter what.
I found my vape. Nothing can hurt me anymore.
Like this riddle, like when I came out, it's like my crowning achievement, but also I'm deeply ashamed of it because it's.
But is it no seagull then?
So it's not. No, it's not right.
Oh, I've got one in four. So. Right, so seagull's not it. I know. Duck.
Duck.
No.
Why?
No.
Well, it leaves the hen.
It's the hen.
Hens are dumb as fuck.
Do you know why the hen finds the vegetables first?
No.
Because a chicken sees her salad.
Right, I'll see you later.
Right, so...
No.
Minus points.
And we're back.
Ellie, can you just maybe like eject him altogether and like
I think you should strip him on the back.
I warned you beforehand it was shit.
And we're back.
Yeah, I might cut.
Oh my god, we're back.
I won't, but I will cut jokes that have been requested to be taken out. Right, round four. Oops, I quizzed it again.
Oh yes.
The music round.
Oh no.
Surely this is where you start clawing back points. Because it's still fairly all to play for, for most years. Right, question one.
Baby Spice is the oldest, so, you know.
Question one. What band had the last UK number one of 1999 and first UK number one of 2000?
This one's a guess, and it shouldn't be, because I'm a music guy.
Maybe some shit in it.
What band had the last UK number one of 1999 and first UK number one of 2000?
This is the one that the answer is not Cannibal Corpse, isn't it? Bastard, I've already used it.
Napalm Death.
Question two. Hey Ya was a 2003 hit for which US duo?
And all
oh, come on!
How is that even a question?
Come on!
How's that a question? Because you've got a question mark at the end there, obviously.
I need to put in some softballs for you.
Softballs.
What was that, Grant?
What?
Just you singing away there.
Yeah. Because I know this song that... I know the band that Billy was referring to, because it was a subject in the first podcast. If you fucking listen to it, Brodie.
Yeah, I do. I just
don't
get
hanged. Question three. Brian Jones, Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin, Kurt Cobain, Amy Winehouse, and other famous singers were all the same age when they died. Nice and cheery. How old was this?
Mate, I fucking...
Come on.
I wrote the answer to that down before you had finished saying the names. Yeah.
I think... Oh, shit.
Lucky bastards.
Nirvana.
I knew what was coming.
Do you need to read that again, or is everyone kind of happy with that?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to think about what age Amy Winehouse was,
because
that's maybe
Tom.
They form my second favourite club after Bullet Club.
I mean, some of them are in both. Okay.
Kurt's in both.
Kurt Joplin's in Bullet Club?
Jason, let's talk about Juice WRLD.
No, I'm not there yet, man.
Question four.
She'd tell him to take his heart in a bag and nobody would hurt him, do you know what I mean? But he died.
No.
Bastard.
Question four. Billy Corgan is the lead singer of which alternative rock band?
NWA. Come on, that's...
What?
You've had enough last dinner. It's enough.
Not funny, didn't laugh, plus your pro wrestler Ian Skinner.
Yeah.
L plus ratio plus Ian Skinner plus...
Everyone happy with that? Did you read that again? Or...
Yeah.
I'm very happy with that.
Question five. Harry, Liam, Niall, Louis and Zane were all members of which British boy band?
Billy! No! Come on!
Listen, wait. I'll hear no slander, okay?
No slander on what, Liam?
Any of them?
Dunkirk.
Specifically Zane.
Are you Zane?
I mean, Liam should be slandering all of them.
Was he not Ring of Honor champion at some point?
No, that was Niall.
No, that's Al Generico. He's children and he's different.
He's children.
Yes, Al Generico eats children.
Also, Al Generico was never Ring of Honor champion, so it's like...
Oh shit, no, he wasn't.
No, but Styles was.
Harry Styles was.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Ah, jeez.
So that's Harry, Liam, Niall, Louis, and Zane, were all members of which British boy band? Question six. Which singer released the single Lonely in 2005?
Yes, a banger.
I love the fact that he would announce that he was from prison.
Oh, so it's a man? Right.
I can't say the name of it because it gives it away, but has anybody heard of that person's type of cryptocurrency?
Yeah.
No?
No?
Once the answer's revealed, I'll tell you, it's the funniest name for anything I've ever heard.
And that is, which singer released the single Lonely in 2005?
I got in shit from my mum because I tried to like download it as a ringtone on those like fucking TV adverts. Jamster. Yeah. And like it ended up taking like 30 quid out of the phone.
Question seven. Which band had a huge international hit album in 2002 called A Rush of Blood to the Head?
To be fair, that reminds me of the days of being on the internet on my phone for like 10 minutes and all of a sudden my £20 top-up's gone.
Oh, I go to like the
top-ups.
No clue.
That was which band had a huge international hit album in 2002 called A Rush of Blood to the Head? Question eight. What Colour Betty is the title of a 1977 hit by the Ram Jam?
I actually know, don't you?
We are
burning
colours into
them.
Okay, if you want to play
that. My pen's ran out again. This is catastrophic.
Yeah, I have mine. Have another one of mine.
Well, actually, that's
right, I put a bit of welly into it and it's back.
Is that a pen? What is that? Tom?
That?
What?
It's a pen, but the top is like broken.
All right.
That was question eight.
Get in the fridge.
What Colour Betty is the title of a 1977 hit by the Ram Jam?
Oh! Yo!
Whoa!
We
can't continue exposing the answer.
No, it's like poetry. It rhymes, you know?
Mm.
Question nine. It's something about Tamagotchi in the background or something.
I can hear something. I don't know what it is. It stopped.
Everyone mute and then just.
Might be my chair.
Okay, that's right. I just want to make sure there's like, just, I don't know. Someone's texting the answers. I don't know how they would, but you know. Question nine. Including streaming figures, what was the best selling UK single of the 2010s?
Did you say UK single or just single?
UK single.
Say the question again, Billy.
Including streaming figures, what was the best-selling UK single of the 2010s?
That's a hell of a punt for me, but fuck it, I'll go for it.
Can I ask a branch question to that? Does that mean it comes from the UK, or it's just in the charts in the UK?
In the UK, so it was a best-selling UK single, so it was sold in the UK.
Best of the super singles.
It doesn't originate from the UK.
I can't give you any more.
Are you just wanting the artist or are you wanting the song or like
the song.
Okay.
Best of the Super UK Cup.
I think I know what the answer is, but I really wish it wasn't the answer, if it's what I'm thinking.
It probably is a thing you're thinking, and that's why you hate it.
Yeah.
And finally, question 10. Which Swedish pop group had a UK number one hit with Cotton Eye Joe in 1995?
No.
Every time that's mentioned, somebody's like, did you know that's about chlamydia? And you just want to punch them in the nuts, man. Like, get chlamydia then.
Hold up. Jason, you know what you've just done?
You did chlamydia.
You're that guy now. You're that guy.
But that's like everybody's that Christmas. When Baby in New York comes on as well, and they're like, that last guy.
You're
not even wrong, Emily. Every Christmas, man.
Oh, dear.
Every Christmas, mad ass,
is it?
And then my dad proceeds to scream the whole second verse of that song, which is very, very concerning.
We only get to sing it one time a year. We can only say the word. Well.
Do you know the Grado?
Question again?
Do you know Grado? No.
Question 10 was, which Swedish pop group had a UK number one hit with Cotton Eye Joe in 1995? Any other ones need repeated?
What was 7?
7 was, which band had a huge international hit album?
Oh, yeah, no, it doesn't matter. You don't need to complete it. I don't know.
Okay. Right, back to the top. What band had the last UK number one of 1999 and the first UK number one of 2000? Grant?
EastEd.
Yes, it is the opposite. It is Westlife.
Yes.
I was like,
who's
it?
I got that.
Emily,
is it
Emily,
I Have a Dream?
Brent.
Is it I Have a Dream or is it Swear It Again?
I think it was like I Had a Dream, Seasons in the Sun. Double A.
Sure, I Had a Dream. Because it was was it not that and Cliff Richard were like fighting for number one or something?
Like Millennium Prayer Again or something.
Yeah.
Mate, Cliff Richard couldn't fight his way out of a fucking nightmare.
Cliff Richard's face is too small for his head.
Didn't think we'd get Cliff Richard slander in this episode, but here we are. Brett.
Billy.
Emily.
Billy. Look at us. Look at us, who'd have thought?
I mean,
look at us.
Ironically, I have that man tattooed on my leg.
What, Cliff Richard?
No, Paul Rudd. Paul Rudd.
I got a tattoo on my leg that isn't of Paul Rudd, but it's of a worm with a wee space helmet on, because now you get like earthworms, that's a space worm. And I think that's pure genius, and my family just looked at me with sheer disappointment, man.
That's a kind
of thank you, Tom. Thank you. Somebody gets
that's
it.
So good. That's so good.
So,
Tom.
For that
Tom,
one,
I got the popularity points again. Like, don't even.
No bonus points.
Back in the game.
Damn it, Tom.
And I get the joke.
So we've got Brent, Grant, and Emily getting that one right. Anyone else get Westlife?
No.
That one fucking hurt, Emily.
Fucking hell.
Excellent.
I understood that reference.
Billy, have you seen the new Batman yet?
No.
Good. Question two.
Question two. First time, it's only the third time I did a post credit. I hope you enjoyed it.
Is that the one with Al Kilmer, yeah?
Yeah, Mr. Meatneck himself.
Meatneck, oh my lord!
It's a shame he can't speak anymore. Yeah. Very sad.
Hey, was sad. A 2003 anyway. Hit for which US duo?
Outcast.
Right, Outcast. Yeah.
I got that one.
Everyone.
Got
that.
Yeah, got that.
I didn't. Yeah. It's Big Boy.
Boy and Andre 3000.
I'll take it right. Everyone, who didn't get it? Sean didn't get it. It was Tom. Tom, you get it.
I got it, yeah. Okay.
Hey. Oh, it's bad when Tom's being celebrated and not me. Oh, my man. That's a shame.
These horrific people, Tom. I'm proud of you.
Right, everyone got that then.
I'm not.
Double check. Everyone. Excellent. Good. All right, Brian Jones, Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin, Kurt Cobain, Amy Winehouse, and other famous singers were all the same age when they died. How old was
27 club.
27.
For life.
Not really.
I mean, technically.
So, did everyone but Tom get 27?
Yeah.
28.
Ah, so close.
Oh, close.
Oh,
I was in Nirvana and I shot the gun.
I only know that because every time we listen to a podcast, it's like, oh, the 27 Club. Fuck off, come on.
The white light.
Somebody once come up to you and you look like Post Malone, he gives me serious 27 Club vibes and then walked away from me.
Oh,
I don't know what they're trying to tell me, but apparently I've got no long left.
You're my hero.
Question 4. Billy Corgan is lead singer of which alternative rock band? Brent.
Smiling politely. I mean, Smashing Pumpkins.
The OK Cranberries.
Right, everyone get that one?
Yeah.
Wow. No.
What? Bikinis.
Tom, you're never going to get booked for NWA. How are you meant to schmooze Billy Corgan without going, hey man, that Rat in a Cage song, dude, really spoke to me.
Like, mate, today really is vibrating.
Okay, so I think everyone but Sean and Tom got that. Fine. Right, next. Five. Harry, Liam, Niall, Louis, and Zane were all members of which British boy band?
Friends.
Tom's got it.
One Direction.
One Direction, correct.
Yes.
I even know that.
Went the wrong way down a one-way.
Listen, don't disrespect 1D, man.
Star.
Everyone got that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yay.
Question six. Which singer released the single Lonely in 2005?
Tom, and tell us who you got.
What? Shit. Shit. I think Kanye West, because I don't fucking know.
How fucking...
Boo.
Acorn.
Burns.
Did everyone else get Acorn?
Yeah.
Oh, see, that's okay. By the
right.
way.
It's
called Acorn.
Acorn. I thought I was just...
Fuck off. It's not called Acorn, is it?
It is, yeah. And it is the official currency of a town in Senegal, which he owns.
Amazing.
Wow. He owns Senegal?
Learning
no,
stuff
owns
in this podcast.
He owns
town,
isn't it? The country.
Question seven. Which band had a huge international hit album in 2002 called A Rush of Blood to the Head? Ian?
Betray.
I know the answer, but I refuse to write it because I hate them.
It's Coldplay. Red.
It's Coldplay.
Sorry. Stop.
Oh my god, really?
I wrote Busted. What a joke, man.
Of Coldplay. Why did I not get that?
That album name is way too metal for those beige fuckers, man.
The first few lyrics of Atreyu Doomsday is A Rush of Blood to the Head.
Thank
I don't expect bonus say. Points. Yeah. I no. just expect the respect of people out there who enjoy
no.
Atreyu.
Yeah, I know. You haven't got any from me. Right. Sorry.
So who got that one then? Coldplay? Oh, got Brent.
Get the friend.
Of course he did. Cool. Emily, you did get it. You just didn't write it down.
Yeah. Bastards.
Hold on, no, you can't, but I got it, but I didn't write it down. Fuck you. You didn't write it down, you didn't get
fuck
it.
Fuck me, fuck you.
No, I just
fight, wrote fight, down. Fight, fight.
I just wrote
wait,
it down.
Wait, hang on.
Go, yeah, no, I got that. I just didn't write it down. Billy, Montafuck.
I'll take majority ruling.
No, don't give me the point because I refuse to write it down. I'll happily take the L on that one because I hate the
okay.
fuckers.
Do you want to
add
that
conviction?
Ratio.
I just enjoyed when you shouted, fuck me, fuck you, because it just reminded me of Goldmember.
I know, I was watching Goldmember like a couple nights ago. It was the best.
Yeah. L plus ratio plus...
I'm not going to lie, I watched the devil night. That's having the best time ever.
What it's Colour me. Betty is the title of 1977 hit by Ram Jam?
And Tom.
Noir.
Black Betty.
Black Betty, yes.
Everyone. Why gotta be black?
Hold on, are you implying that it's Black Betty?
Shut the fuck up.
Understandable, have a nice day.
Billy, can I interject for a mere moment?
Yes.
What was question 10?
Which Swedish pop group had a UK number one hit with Cotton Eye Joe in 1985?
Cool, move on. Let's go then.
Question 9. Included streaming figures, what was the best-selling UK single in the 2010s? Brent?
Was it Shape of You by Ed Sheeran?
It was Shape of You by Ed Sheeran.
Yeah. Piece of shit.
Well,
it's the number one song on Spotify.
On the back of that, though, do you know Hotline Bling came out 7 years ago?
What the fuck?
What is that?
Imagine first year.
Great, Hotline Bling.
What's that?
First year on that came out, Jesus.
Wait,
everyone
what?
Get that? Everyone get Shape of You?
Wait, sorry. Sorry. Can we just go... Sean, what the fuck did you just say?
I was in first year. It's like high school when that came out.
I know when that Hotline Bling...
I remember that day it came out.
I feel sick.
It just came out, but...
Genuinely.
Sean,
it just came out.
I mean, do
you know what that is? What is that?
I think it was S2 or 3. What was that,
too? I was 25. I was 25 years old when that came out.
No, that's what I'm saying. It just came out.
You used to call me on my iPhone, rose gold, 6 plus 64 gigabyte.
It sounds a bit shit. I don't even know what it is, but that sounds pretty bad.
Remember the wee dance he done, yeah, and then somebody was dropped a tennis racket in his home?
We ping pong, yeah, it was fucking great.
To be fair, just... he only makes music to get himself in with teenage girls anyway, so...
Come on!
I lost the one the other day as well. Oof.
We're shooting.
Final question of the round. Which Swedish pop group had a UK number one hit with Cotton Eye Joe in 1985?
Avicii.
And Cousins.
Rednecks.
I've wrote that way at exit then, was I?
Yeah, that's it.
Yes! Come on, the boys.
Right, so
that's in my road trip playlist.
Swedish bands use the name the Rednecks. They're Swedish, so...
But it's not Rednecks, it's Rednecks.
Rednecks?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rednecks.
Sorry.
Right, so who got that wrong?
Brodie,
Jason.
Sorry, I was just speaking for you. Nothing rude about that at all.
Nobody speaks for me,
right? Right, you go back to
no, Brodie, so there's this thing called the quiz. I've got this new thing called mansplaining, right?
Okay, what is mansplaining again?
I'll explain it for Brodie and Emily. So when you're
two women who could absolutely kick the shit out of you, by the way. So please be careful.
I
give no fucks. I'm just here to be called Queen Speech. That's it. I give no fucks.
See, to be fair, you've only been called it like once by you.
I was hoping everyone else would call me it, okay?
Oh.
My mum says I'm cool.
Elsa already been your mum says you're cool, around,
darling. You're cool.
Thank you.
For fuck's sake, Tom.
Is it?
Get in the fridge!
Tom,
I don't
shut
know
up.
What this get in the fridge part is, but I get in the fridge. It's a good point.
Get fridged.
I was thinking a Tomb Raider.
Been fridged. Send this to your friends to totally fridge them.
To be a star,
I think a Green Lantern over here get fridged.
Yeah. Emily,
I'm making that meme as soon as this podcast quiz fuckfest ends.
We've got one more round.
Shut up, fridge.
Right. So, apparently, I've got Brent and Grant with 10 points.
Yes.
Excellent. Next is Sean and Jason, both with 7. No, sorry. Emily with 8.
Yes.
Sean and Jason with 7.
I think I've got 8. Hold on.
Hold on. I think I've got 8.
Wait, no.
The ones I got wrong were number 1 and number 7.
All right, so you okay, of course you got Akon. You got Akon. Cool, right. So
I've got 7.
You got 8. All right, I've got you have 6. That's fine. 7. And Brodie with 6. Tom with 4.
I appreciate you begging me up, Billy, but it was 5.
Billy, I did get 6. You're just fucking, like, come on, keep up.
I'm trying. I thought I figured out quite a good system this year for doing the maths. It clearly was.
Well, not. Actually, no, I did get 7 because I got Channel 4 in round 2.
No.
Oh my god! Shut up with Channel 4.
I got MTV.
As we go into the last round, in first place is Brent with 41. Got Grant in second with 35. Jason with 33. Emily with 31. Sean with 24, Ian with 21, Brodie with 16, and Tom in double figures with 12.
I'm calling it back, boys. Let's go.
This whole Brett thing, thing is just because he doesn't want to play postage. Like, this is a setup.
It really is. How much is he paid you?
I have received no money from anyone. Full stop.
I have no money to give. I am unemployed.
I can send some money, Billy, if you want.
So because he's not got money, it means he's not got money for postage. This is a setup. It's better say.
Thank you, Queensby.
Already paid off, Billy. That's why he's got money.
For the next birthday bonanza, to make sure that Brent Carter doesn't win another quiz, Can the participants of the quiz write their own round for everyone to do? That way, that there's like a there's a non-biased aspect of it.
Oh my god!
They can't participate in their own round.
What you're just saying is, I am a gimp.
That's genius, but also shambles. Genius.
That's what we're going for. Shambles is what we promised in this episode, and that
is what we have delivered.
Shambles are the only thing I know how to provide.
I don't.
The final round, you'll be all glad to hear. And we've got like half an hour to go before Love Island starts, so it should be done dusted in time.
Little chef's hat for Tom.
Round five is called Life is a Quiztery. It's the Scottish wrestling round because it's a Scottish wrestling podcast.
Oh my god.
Boys, this is where I fucking go to shit. Here we go.
It's quite some of the questions are tenuous when it comes to Scottish wrestling, but it's
I just got the quiz title. Ah, oh, that's clever.
Life is a quiz. Like, you know,
I put far more work in the titles than I did the actual quiz, I'll be honest with you. This point.
That's okay.
These glasses are pushing my mustache into my mouth and it's very uncomfortable.
Grant, you still doing wrestling?
You're old enough to grow a mustache.
I'm 25.
2 years left.
I'm on camera. You can see I have a beard.
Back when I was your age, Hotline Bling came out.
Much from the glasses.
Back when I was your age.
Listen, I may look silly, but it's a known fact that glasses are +5 intelligence. Therefore, I'm currently +15 and somehow still losing.
I know you said.
Well, I have glasses and I'm losing, so I think.
I'm sure there's a joke to be made about +15, but we'll move on.
Tom, you're just here to make place look pretty.
Yeah, generally. That's it.
By comparison,
get in the fucking fridge.
Fine.
This is it, right? No, last round. Tom, come back.
No, fuck Tom. Tom, come back. Get in the fridge.
Tom,
take your camera to the fridge.
Tom.
Now, this is what we in the industry like to call hazing, folks.
Right, boys, we're going to the fridge.
McIvor looks very much past his bedtime, so.
Hey, well, I was fucking working at 6, so that's maybe yes.
Right, let's do this. Hey, 10 more questions.
Right.
Yeah. Question one.
I'm in the fridge.
Here we go. Question one. Which wrestler appeared on WWE Raw in 2014 in a speaking role as a representative for the Kremlin to congratulate Rusev on winning the WWE United States Championship?
Easy, because we told the story of how he got it every bloody week.
Bit fucking rude, man, okay.
But there was two?
Only one spoke.
Had a speaking role.
Oh, you cheeky fuckers.
No, it's not a cheeky fucker. He specified in the question a speaking role.
Ian Skinner, I can jump through screens and I will come to you and
fucking
I will.
Fucking do it. I'll kneecap you with my Glock.
Can you please come from me?
Okay, Arn Anderson.
Kevin Head, but he can do Timberland boots.
Brody, that's not that impressive. I've come to Ian Skinner from my screen every day.
Which wrestler appeared on WWE Raw 2014 in a speaking role as a representative for the Kremlin to congratulate Rusev on winning the WWE United States Championship?
That was the year the WWE Network launched as well.
It was.
$9.99.
But it certainly wasn't Savio
Vega,
unfortunately. So
or
Paul
Bertschuk. It's all coming
together. Is it with Paul
Bertschuk? Great, man. It was on my birthday game.
If you miss him, just watch Pirates of the Caribbean or something.
You watch Pirates of the Caribbean, bitch.
No, he misses Paul Burchill because he likes to shag his sister as well.
I don't know. No,
forgot about that.
I don't want to say that with so much
enthusiasm. We don't acknowledge
really
that.
Really, question two?
Question two. We've got, who played the character Buster in River City?
Fuck knows.
Grant, you're still doing the wrestling.
I mean, let's be honest, who saw it? It was awful. It was bad.
It was terrible.
I am not saying anything.
The answer is me.
Oh, Ian Skinner.
Can we move on? Can we move on to question three?
Question three.
Was this the same Buster from Tiny Toons?
Is River City still a thing?
I have no idea.
Question three?
Question three. Who was the first wrestler to become a three-time WWE Women's Tag Team Champion? Thought this would be a nice soft round to finish the quiz on. So the questions are a little bit easier.
Quiz on my face.
I'm sick of hearing that fucking quiz name. There's been about three fucking different teams that have come out of my local pub quiz that have had quiz in the face.
Can we come up with quiz teams? They're
so funny. I thought we were going to do quiz team names.
We're a bit late in the round, but I mean, if you want to.
Let me just do it anyway.
My quiz team name is Queez Nuts.
Rehab is for quitters. That's my...
Rehab is for quitters?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
To be fair, my old team name used to be the Bill Murray Experience, and then we would change it slightly every week as I went on, like the Bill Murray Experience 2000.
I think my quiz
name is... The team name that we always have is horrendous, and I shouldn't say it.
Oh, you need to now.
You need to.
No, it's not even that. It's just Protestant Wank Flakes.
Tom, what's the name of the Rock's character in Moana?
Do you know anything? Like, anything at all? Do you know anything?
I legit just...
By the way, comes from me.
That film came out.
All I watch is wrestling and YouTube. That's it. I'm sorry.
Brody, what's the name of the Rock's character in Moana?
Moana?
Maui.
Maui.
Maui, balls in your mouth. Question four.
Right, it wouldn't be a SWN podcast quiz without, or any episode without mentioning WrestleZone. So who faced and defeated Luke King Sharp in the Battle of the Big Men at WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy 2017?
I'm taking that's a guess on this Skinner. One.
My God, Skinner, that set up.
I think the best part about that setup was it shat all over Tom, and I got a D's Nuts joke in. So, like, it's like the best of both worlds.
It's not even that. It's the sheer long-term commitment to it that you wait for. Just asking people in the group just to make sure you got the answer.
I only asked two people.
That was question four. Who faced and defeated Luke King Sharp in the Battle of the Big Men at WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy 2017?
I'm going to assume it's the one story that he tells.
Yeah. I think he's got two. So, you know, 50-50. So question five, who was the first Discovery Wrestling Y Division champion?
What line was that?
Someone needs to feed their Tamagotchi. I think it's Tom. Everyone mute apart from Tom.
You asked this last year.
Did I?
And I think I've wrote the same answer as last year, and I got it wrong last year. But I'm still sticking to my answer.
That wasn't a question last year.
How would you know? You weren't there.
He won last year.
I won it!
He doesn't even go here!
I thought that was Tom.
That you fully told for no reason.
Yeah, Tom. Silence with again at tight.
Tom, get in the fucking fridge.
I'll give Thomas. Tom a hug. Please, at once, enter the refrigerator. It is so important.
Tom, when I see you next week, Tom, can you not hate me, please? Because I could
do it. The fog is coming.
Question
the fog
six.
Is coming.
Question six. Question 10.
Question six. Who did Drew McIntyre defeat to win his first WWE Intercontinental Championship?
I think it's this.
I was going to say Trent Barretta, but I don't think he ever won.
No, he didn't.
So that's question six. Who did Drew McIntyre defeat to win his first WWE Intercontinental Championship? Question seven. Which comedian appeared at the conclusion of the Kelvin Brawl?
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Which comedian appeared at the conclusion of the Kelvin Brawl?
That was a beautiful moment.
Shite fun fact, that's the way I decided to fucking try wrestling.
Which comedian appeared at the conclusion of the Kelvin Brawl?
Ah, there was two?
No, at the conclusion of Kelvin Brawl.
What's the
end?
After the match.
Conclusion.
If your answer was Amy Schumer, you were wrong. She was never a comedian.
Hey, I agree.
Question.
I agree with that because it's such a generic thing, but I hate it.
Low hanging fruit, guys. That type of
podcast.
Question 8. Who teamed with Grado to form the Lowlanders?
I know this one.
Question 8. Who teamed with Grado to form the Lowlanders?
I put this in the source.
Oh, wait.
Because it's during COVID, so I'll be annoyed if you don't get it. And 2, I'll be annoyed if you don't get it because
he is my father.
The guy gave me one of the funniest matches in my life. Because
we've just given the answer away.
I was there.
Apart from Tom, who Grado still doesn't know who it is.
I don't know who it is.
Question 9.
Gilbert Gottfried.
We've got the penultimate question now of the quiz. We're almost there. Which wrestler is credited to have played Saxon Knight in Transformers: The Last Knight?
Did you say Scottish or British?
Scottish.
Scottish. Oh,
well, I said which wrestler, but it's a Scottish wrestling ground. So
cool. Thank you.
I've not seen the movie, Joe.
Obviously,
take a wild guess.
So,
literally. Think Saxon Knight and think Scottish wrestling.
What does that? That does nothing. That does nothing.
It totally does. Okay.
So I'll repeat the question again. Which wrestler is credited to have played Saxon Knight in Transformers: The Last Knight?
Scottish wrestler. Saxon Knight.
Skinner,
this doesn't help, Skinner. As much as you think it does, it doesn't help.
Listen, I don't know the name of the character, but I know, like, if. Yeah.
I'm glad finally. You know that, but saying it slower doesn't make it any fucking easier.
I think you need more some mansplaining.
I think you need a slap.
I think I need an adult.
And finally. My favourite question from last year as well. When this episode goes out on July 1st, including this one, how many SWN podcast episodes have been released?
Oh, you fucking...
All right, what's your fucking language?
Fuck, Thomas.
Little shit, man.
So that's...
My frick.
I even have a tiebreaker question, but I've got a feeling I'm not going to need it.
Can you put it in anyway for like 10 bonus points?
You know
that would defeat the purpose of the last two.
Tiebreaker. Depending on what the scores are, I might throw a point. I might throw out there for a couple points. When this episode goes out on July 1st, including this one, how many SWN podcast episodes have been released? Not recorded because there's more.
Is this including July 1st?
So obviously, there's episodes coming out like
tomorrow,
Between now and then. So on July 1st, how many episodes will have been released?
Does the Liu Kang Sharp Dojo series count?
It's SWN podcast only.
Fuck.
Billy.
As if Tom actually counted the Liu Kang Sharp Dojo series. Montafuck.
Yeah, no, Billy and I sort of didn't.
So, I am known for being really, really fast at peeing.
Right, we missed the first half of that, and all I got was nothing, and then I'm known for really, really fast peeing. And that's
I'm really sorry. I need to pee really fast.
Fastest bladder in the West.
Yeah, like legit.
She's already peed. She's done.
Right.
She was
while
running
we're waiting
to the toilet in her trousers fell down.
While we're waiting, any questions need repeated?
Are you saying Biscuity Boyle got caught in a revolving door and his trousers fell down?
His trousers fell down.
I've lost cause at this point, Billy. I'm just going to go sit in the fridge.
You've got double points. So you got, well, sorry, double figures, not double points. Double figures. That's commendable.
No, give Tom double points. That's round.
Is everyone okay with that? If everyone's all right with that, I'll go with majority rule.
I'm confident that that's fine.
Okay. Tom is getting double points in the last round.
You can tell Brodie that when she comes back.
No.
No. Just don't tell her. Don't
tell her.
Don't
tell
her.
Work it out for herself.
That's what
she gets for peeing.
Imagine peeing.
For the final time.
Are you not embarrassed?
For me?
I imagine peeing. Ready.
I'm 31 years old. I have the bladder of a 75-year-old. Are you shitting me?
No, we're peeing.
No, we're peeing.
I've never shat anybody in my life, okay?
Nice. Hey.
You are
So, final round. First question. Which wrestler appeared on WWE Raw in 2014 in a speaking role as a representative for the Kremlin to congratulate Rusev on winning the WWE United States Championship? Ian.
Joe Henry.
Yes.
Yeah. Tom, get 2 points.
No. He sucks.
I know. You missed this.
You missed
Tom's
it.
Got double points for the last round and you missed the vote.
Question Tom gets right in this round, double points for it.
He'll still fucking lose, it's not my problem.
I appreciate you guys.
Question
Fuck
two.
Off, get in the fridge.
Who played the character Buster in River City?
Grado.
Grado, everyone get Grado.
I'm pro wrestler Odar the Great.
So I'm
you say Tom. Odar the Great?
Odar the Great is still Grado? Do you even watch professional wrestling?
He gets sacked
to Impact and then come back in a really revealing mask.
Yeah.
And he wore his singlet inside out.
He's defiant.
That wasn't him. They should be saying Mr. America was Hulk Hogan or some person like that.
Never proven.
No, but no conspiracy.
They should tell me House Kid was all.
Question three.
I didn't bluff.
They should tell me fake Diesel wasn't actually Diesel.
No.
I was petrol.
What about fake
Kid? Who was the first wrestler to become a 3-time WWE Women's Tag Team Champion, Brent?
Nikki Cross / Nikki ASH. 2 times with Alexa Bliss and 1 time with Rhea Ripley.
Yep, everyone get Nikki.
You can make it right.
Although I effed up and went in school and wrote Nikki Stones.
That's right. No, we said no sing-along. We said no sing-along. We're not changing the backstory of the song. No.
Please God help me.
Question four. Who faced and defeated Luke King Sharp in the Battle of the Big Men at WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy 2017?
Devon Dudley?
The other one.
Is it your fave?
It's Hornswoggle.
The one I keep getting. I used to get called by one of the green tights.
I wrote Dylan Postel. Am I a piece of shit or nah? I didn't know. What?
Right, who got Hornswoggle?
Yeah.
Glorious.
No, I wrote a Scottish wrestler. Sorry.
That was weird.
Not funny, didn't laugh.
Hang on, concentrate. Oh no. I gave only 1 point. In last
funny, round. Funny, weird.
Who was the first Discovery Wrestling Y Division champion? Brent.
Chris Sabin.
Yeah.
Excellent. It's pronounced Saban.
I still wrote the same as last year and I still got it wrong.
It wasn't a question last year.
It must have been
The question was, what is the question?
So is that everyone but Tom and Brodie that got that?
Yep.
Excellent. Right, next. Who did Drew McIntyre defeat to win his first WWE Intercontinental Championship? Oh, Tom knows.
Chris Jericho?
No!
Oh.
Ian. Tom, why did he get?
Was it Johnny Morbius?
Yes, it was John Morrison. That's
it wasn't Morbin time that night.
My Norm McDonald impression. So, what's the new Jared Leto film? No wonder it's called Morbius, because I ain't seen Morbius on the screen in a long time.
I can do a Norm McDonald impression as well, but I don't know if it'll be appropriate.
It's Morbin time.
I mean, right. I can do it.
Who didn't get it? Tom didn't get it. Sean didn't get it. Cool. Right.
Brodie.
You got it. Brodie didn't get it.
No. Dude, please. Of course I didn't fucking get it.
Why?
I can do Norm McDonald doing
But right, Reynolds.
Maybe the Lancers were the friends we made along the way.
Hey, I got a funny hat. We got bigger.
Yeah.
Question 7. Which comedian appeared at the conclusion of the Kelvin Brawl, Brent?
Frankie Boyle.
Frankie Boyle. That's the answer I was looking for. Is that everyone? I assume except Tom.
I was there all by myself, like a fucking loner. I remember because I had no friends.
I remember that too.
That night for literally no reason except for the thing I'd done.
I put my hands up. I put Rap Florence because
I remember that. I remember that, Brodie, like seeing you over there, like just by yourself, no friends, looking like Tom.
Tom's just catching strays.
Made me sad. I don't want to be like Tom. Come on, please.
Nobody wants to be like Tom.
Nobody wants to be like Tom.
Everybody hates Tom.
Titanium,
who else
like
but Tom?
Tinfoil Tom
Atlas. Tom, like Tom's all right.
Tinfoil Tom Atlas.
No, hold on.
I'm impressed that Tom's still here.
I
think it's more impressive Tom is still here because he's been mercilessly hazed for the last 5 rounds.
I live in the same city as him. I'm going to bump into him at some point and just going to feel really bad.
You're
going to walk into my work and I'm just going to dead eye you. Like
every time I've went to that gym, you've never been there. I'm convinced it's a fucking sham.
But I've never seen you in there.
It's a gimmick.
You don't go to the gym.
Nah. I don't.
But it goes to the game.
Bye.
Guy? You're big fat phony. Big phony.
Oh, a guy.
A great big fat phony.
This guy's a phony.
Question 8. We're almost there.
Take 8 tip for 400.
Who teamed with Grado to form the Lowlanders?
There it is.
Brody.
My father, Brendan Barr.
Dun 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 Barr.
Tom got one. Tom got 2 points.
Hold on a minute. No, wait. Yeah. Why have you changed your name to Ape Pit and Turd Ferguson?
Funny name.
Funny name.
Funny. So everyone get that? Everyone got Brendan Barr?
Wait, Jason, didn't he F5 you?
Yes, he did.
Dun dun dun.
After it, he came up to him and you take too much meat. I was like, you told me to take it. I saw one, I liked it.
You know, this is a jumping neck breaker. Jumping clotheslines me in the mouth.
Which wrestler is credited? Ultimate question, which wrestler is credited to have played Saxon Knight in Transformers The Last Knight? Brent.
Gang.
Westlife.
Oh!
It was Wolfgang. Yep.
Oh. I thought it was Ian Skinner.
I thought it was Ape Tit over there.
Cheers.
Ah, it's funny. Funny name.
Funny.
Right, who didn't get it? Okay, cool. Usual suspects.
You said, I didn't want to say it.
Right, last question.
Take us home.
And then we'll reveal all of the quiz. Mm-hmm. When this episode goes out on July 1st, including this one, how many SWN podcast episodes have been released? Brody.
216.
How the fuck did you get this wrong?
What?
Right.
Right.
Is it 170?
Why? What?
See, come I on. Put I said 164.
Nobody cares what you said, Tom.
Ian,
because
see, I know I'm sorry, Sean Connery over there.
169. The amount of men that your mother has slept with.
I'm assuming nobody got 168.
No, that's not a funny number.
I was close.
I mean, I didn't hear the next
number, bro. I just wanted to hear Billy swear. That's all.
Turd Ferguson.
No, it looks like a 3
there
at
we
first.
Go. 168. Someone's been paying attention.
I've been paying attention.
You can't not.
Oh no, you were. Yeah, I'll give you that. I'll give you that, Ian. You did. It was 169. That was close. fun fact, really, though, if all goes well,
you're not finishing on like a 10 rounded number.
That's kind
of
fun fact. If all goes well, there will, up to January 1st, there's 168 episodes. There is going to be an episode 169 to finish the season.
But, no, you can't do that. You need to end it on like,
nice,
like a number with a zero.
No, I don't. It's 169.
What are you doing?
Right, Brodie, what if the options were ending it at 169 or ending it at 170, but the last guest is Tom?
But Brodie, what if the options were unlimited day games?
No games.
But no video games or games. Unlimited games.
But no games.
I would choose Tom. And then I just wouldn't watch it, so that's fine with me.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
So that was the last question. Did people, while doing the score, do you want the tiebreaker? Just for...
Wait. Do we need it?
No, because I've won. You just don't need it.
No, guys, sorry. We all know I've won, so we're just going to can.
Are you partaking?
That's what your mother said to me last night, Tom.
Right.
I mean, she's not going to watch it anyway, so that's fine.
So the last, the tiebreak.
I didn't watch it either.
Me neither.
My dad's Stevie Wizard will watch it, so it's okay.
Incredibly vain.
Right, so the tiebreaker was going to be, to the nearest minute, how long have I spoken to Scotty Swift across four seasons of the SWN podcast?
Oh, no.
420.
6 hours.
Are you just assuming that we watch your material, like, and pay attention to, like, the numbers and shit?
Wait, are you telling me you don't watch in time every episode?
I mean, I don't have anything else to do, so of course I fucking...
So once you skip out the intro music...
This is almost like Wheel of Fortune,
hang on,
where the closest number gets the bonus.
Hang on. I put 69 LMFAO.
Oh, it's 78.
I wrote 4 hours and 20 minutes.
I guess 6 hours.
Jason.
In my hours.
Okay.
Right. I have got...
Right.
I don't know how to split up into minutes.
I've got hours and minutes.
I've got 10 hours, 22 minutes.
That is 9 hours and 22 minutes.
Damn!
9 hours and 22 minutes.
Damn.
And nothing important was said in any episode. Right, so in that round, I've got...
Billy, main distinction, do I get double points?
Just for that round.
No!
Just for that last round.
You got double points.
It's the Make-A-Wish round.
Yes.
No, John Cena.
So from my calculations...
I'll tell this story once the recording's finished.
No, we don't care.
We got Grant...
Tell the story when it's finished and we're all not here. Good idea.
Grant with 10 points in that round. Right? 10 points.
I had 9. I'll be honest. 9. I messed up. I had D1 instead of Hornswoggle.
Shocker. I do not know these
I live in the fucking central belt, for fuck's sake. Since I get picked up north, oh no. Wait, when's UPW coming back?
Fuck's sake. Right, so from that, I've got Brent Grant and Emily got 9 in that round.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Yes. Jason and Sean got 8.
I got 8 as well, cunt.
Whoa!
I'm sorry, I had 7. Are you counting Channel 4 again?
No. No.
Yeah,
Joe Hendry, Grado, Nikki Storm. I got Devon Dudley. No. Chris Sabin, Johnny Morbius. I got Rab Florence. Glendon Barr, Wolfgang, and 169.
Well, the last one's wrong.
Nice.
No, you can't say, well, I mean, by the time it comes out, maybe we'll have 169 not give me the point.
July 1st,
eat my entire ass, Billy. Yeah. Eat my entire ass.
Delicious.
7.
Dinner.
With the double points, Tom got 6 and Brody got 5 in that round.
I cannot.
Yes!
No,
you got less than Tom.
Not, I cannot have less than Tom.
Less than Tom.
Less than Tom.
Less than Tom. Less than Tom. Less than Tom.
After 2.5 hours, we've got...
No, she's going to kill me next week, so great. Oh, well,
I mean, you haven't won, so it's fine. There's no posthumous award. With 50 points and retaining the Day of Birth Bonanza Championship,
I call bullshit.
Is Brent Carter. In second place is...
There we go.
Oh, hang on, I have to look.
Was it Todd Ferguson himself?
It was. Brad McIvor with 45. And then I've got Jason Hyde with 41. Emily Hayden Queens Beach with 40.
Yes.
Sean Martin with 32. Ian Skinner with 28. Brody with 21. And in last place, Tom Atlas with 18 points.
What does that say?
I want to die.
It doesn't even make 50%.
Tom.
So there, I mean,
I've got a big pencil.
There's no fun way to conclude this, but
there's not, because Brent
there's a fun way to conclude it. We go round and everyone answers the question. So would you rather have unlimited bacon, no video games, or games, unlimited games,
but no games? I think we should talk about what you've done in 99 with a pair of Timberlands.
Yeah.
And with that, congratulations to Brent Carter for remaining undefeated.
He's gone.
Fix!
Thank you. Right, guys, you can say fix all you want. It's not a fix. I've just, I just retain shit knowledge.
Tom screwed Tom.
Ellie, you know how you're having a kid soon?
Yep.
And you need, as many kid stuff and all that stuff and, spare cash as you can get. What the fuck did he give you?
To be fair, I had asked if I managed to retain my title, if he would name his child after me. And then somehow he came up with a trophy. So I'm like, I'm not happy. I thought there was going to be a little baby Brent, but...
Nobody's
about
little baby
time. Well, what
did you call
Wayne?
Or the fierce city hooligan?
So with that being said, yes, Brent Carter has won the You're Awesome trophy, and he will receive it in the post, post haste. Great, I don't have to ask for his address because he gave me it last year.
Put your cup down.
I've not moved. Same place.
Excellent. That's fine. That'll be with you in the next couple of days. Please don't reveal it until, July 2nd.
Reveal your address.
Oh, okay. 33. No.
But thank you all for taking part. This has actually been a bit more structured than I thought it would be. I'll just put that out there.
Is it structured?
This is run a lot better when there's no bonus points.
Well, the armrest come off my chair. Where is the structure to this?
I mean, to be honest, like I said, bonus points, once the bonus points were removed, I think we were, it ran a bit smoother. And everyone was nice and honest with their answers, which was good as well. So,
I mean, I wanted bonus points, but okay.
So thank you all for joining me for a Day of Birth Bonanza. This has been the end of the season. It's been a really worthy end of the season. And thank you all for coming on to the podcast in the past and probably have you on in season 5, whatever that is. But if anyone with any closing...
Season 5. I've got a quote. I've got a quote we can leave this on. It's my favorite Bruce Lee quote. Water is malleable, transformable, yet powerful. You put water in a teapot, it becomes a teapot. Put water in the glass, it becomes a glass. Yeah. Put water through a pipe, it becomes a pipe. Be like water, my friends. I love Kung Fu.
Fuck this,
All right, we'll leave it with that. Okay, thank you very much for listening.
Fuck Tom.
You've got this far.
the chase and the hunting. I set the pace when I'm running. I always take what I want and I always give it 100. Don't need a bank, no, I'm funded. Play the game like...
Hey Tom, you quite arrived. Tom. Who let Tom out of the fridge?